Richter. Richter for Opilka. He fires. He scores! Or pass out in front. Here's a shot from Quinn. He scores! Far side. It's Opilka. He fires. He scores! Here comes Joe Nolan. He can have a breakaway. Nolan moving on his back and a shot. He scores!
Thomas Kolas. He's in. He shoots. Out in front. Score! The captain is the savior again!
take me where the hockey players face off down the rink. And the Stanley Cup is all filled up for the champs who win the drink. Now the final flick of a hockey stick and a one gigantic scream. The puck is in, the home team wins the good old hockey game. Oh, the good old hockey game is the best game you can name. And the best game you can name is the good old hockey game. Oh, the good old hockey game is the best game you can name. And the best game you can name is the good old hockey game.
Good evening, Anthony, from the Big Pond in Champaign, Illinois. It's a Saturday night edition of Illini Hockey presented by YouTube. Tonight, it's the conclusion of a weekend series between the Illinois Fighting Illini and the visiting Illinois State Redbirds. Alongside Eric Fisher, I'm Stephen Cohn. And Eric, the Illini now 3-0 in the season. They took last night's game 4-0 from the Redbirds. We should expect more of the same tonight, shouldn't we?
Against Michigan State, would give credit to them. In past years, they've done that against teams like Michigan State and ISU. They would come out a little complacent with not as much as energy on a Saturday game, and the other team would start handing it to them a little bit. But I don't feel like that's that way with this team this year. That's not the culture that head coach Nick Fabrini has established over the last couple of seasons. So I think Illinois is going to come out. I think they're going to come out with the same kind of energy and motor they had last night, and I think you should expect another Illinois win tonight against ISU.
Yeah, and four different goal scorers last night. Kind of talk about how this year it's been, especially that bottom six, but just up and down the line for the lineup for the Illini, there's been contributors.
Yeah, I mean, it just shows how much depth is on this team. I mean, you have guys like Justin Reese, John Moskowitz, Evan Sabo. I mean, those guys have just been stepping up. Stephen Quinn, who's having a great start to his season. And before with the previous Illini teams, it would be their top two lines that would carry them, but their lack of depth would hurt them once they started getting into conference play and farther into the season. But last year, their depth really showed in third and fourth lines, and this year it's just starting to show even more. I mean, Nick Novoselic, a guy that played D2 for a couple seasons, he's coming up and been a huge contributor for the Illini the last 2 years. And now it's not the top two lines anymore doing all the scoring. It's all throughout the lineup. And the defensive pairings are also stepping in and contributing offensively. So it's just really going to show the amount of talent and depth that's on this Illini team.
Yeah, we could talk about that offense all night long. They've scored 24 goals over three games, an average of 8 per night so far over the Illini's 3 wins. But how about the defense? They haven't allowed a goal now in 2-plus games, about 7 periods now, without allowing a goal. This defense has been stepping up in front of its goaltenders.
Yeah, it's been suffocating its opponents along the boards. Once that puck gets in there, you just see a swarm of Illini defenders just get in there and fight for the puck. And it's just really – it goes back to the effort that this Illini team puts in defensively. Scoring goals is the fun part. It's all the flashy things. But defense is what's going to win you hockey games. And that's what the Illini have been doing. They've been causing so much disruption in the neutral zone for their opponents throughout the season so far, creating turnovers, which are leading to offensive opportunities on the other end. And then they've been getting stellar goaltender play, too. Jake Barnhart is having a good start to his season so far. Bird's going to be in between the pipes tonight. We'll see how he does. And so it's just the Illini is getting good play by their netminders and also getting good play defensively in the neutral zone, really disrupting their opponents.
Yeah, let's touch on that for one more second. Nick Fabrini, early on in the season, obviously, kind of rotating his goaltenders, giving them opportunities. Jake Barnhart has played 5 of the Illini's 9 periods so far this season. 2 shutout periods last weekend for Donovan Bird against Michigan State, and 2 periods allowing 1 goal for Royce Allred. You like this kind of strategy right now, because the Illini do next week, they go North Dakota, they play Minot State, they play Jamestown. He's got to get his guys some rhythm, and so far he's been kind of switching up the goaltenders.
Yeah, and he just wants to make sure that everyone's as ready as possible heading into next weekend. So that's why you're giving Donovan Bird to start tonight. In case something were to happen to Jake Barnhart, you want to make sure he's ready to go come next weekend. And then you gave Jake the start last night to make sure that he's ready to go as well. He's getting a good feel for a game, make sure he's comfortable come a couple big games next weekend. Nick Fabrini's done this in the previous seasons, rotating guys like Joe Olin, I mean, David Heflin, Zev Grummet-Morris when he was a goaltender here. He's now an assistant coach for the Illini. But Fabrini's always, these first couple of weeks in the season, he's always rotated his goaltenders, trying to make sure everyone's as fresh as possible in case someone were to go down with injury.
And then just, I feel like another Illini victory is coming. No reason not really to believe that so far based on what we've seen the first three games. But what's the one key for the Illini tonight to make sure they grab their fourth win of the season?
I think they just have to come out with the same kind of effort and mentality they came out last night. They're not, make sure they come out, don't underestimate this ISU team, because ISU only held them to four goals compared to last weekend against Michigan State, where they just ran over their, skated all over their opponent. And Mark Hayden had a very strong game in net before them, and so I would expect another solid performance from him. So the Illini have to come out with the same sense of urgency that they came out last night, wanting to win this hockey game as soon as the game started and not come out complacent.
And it's not an Illini hockey pregame show without a score prediction. So Eric, what do you got for tonight's score in the series weekend finale between Illinois State and Illinois?
I'm gonna go 6-1 Illinois tonight. I think they're gonna put a couple more goals on that ISU. I don't think ISU is gonna be coming in this hockey game all too, let's just say, confidence it won't be too high with the ISU Redbirds after just getting dominated last night. And so I feel like Illinois is going to put a couple more shots on goal. I think Donovan Bird will give up one goal, but that's nothing to worry about at all. So I think it's going to be a 6-1 hockey game.
You've got the Illini shutout streak coming to an end in 2+ games. We'll see what happens there. Donovan Bird's in goal. The Illini looking to advance to 4-0 for the second straight season. All that next, Illini Hockey on YouTube. We'll be right back.
Nothing ever comes without a consequence and cost. Tell me, will the stars align? Will heaven step in? Will it save us from a sin? Will it? Cause this house of mine stands strong. That's the price you pay.
Welcome back to the Illinois Ice Arena, the Big Bond in Champaign, Illinois, alongside Eric Fisher. I'm Stephen Cohen, and we got more Illini hockey tonight between Illinois and Illinois State. And now we've got Illinois' starting lineup, and the lineup for Illinois tonight, it's that fourth line being rewarded. Evan Sabo, Justin Reese, Ricky Haddon by their head coach, Nick Fabrini. I like that move. This has been a dangerous line so far. Maybe the best line Illinois has yet.
Yeah, I know. Good move on head coach Nick Fabrini. He's riding the hot hand right now. Last night, that was the most productive line for the Illini. They're just extremely active from start to finish. And so Fabrini just giving him a chance to play against the opponent's top line. And so that's going to give him a little bit more reps, especially once they start getting in the conference play where the level of competition just rises more. So that's just what this move is tonight, is just trying to give the lower line guys the chance to go up against the other team's top guys to get them more ready once conference play starts, especially come next weekend.
I just think more so it's even a reward for these guys. They've just been great so far.
Yeah.
Some of the hardest workers on this team, Justin Reese, Ricky Haddon, they weren't guys getting playing time much last year. And Evan Sabo, he was a scratch for some games. So it's a line that so far is earning their playing time, and he's showing it with their starting lineup performance.
Yeah, I mean, the only player out of these five guys that got consistent ice time was Tyler O'Pilker. Everyone knows they've been scratches from time to time. And so seeing them come out and have a great start to this season like they are now is just really good to see, especially knowing how much work they come in. They come in between about 4 to 6 about every day practicing. They don't have to. This is a club team, but the guys put in the effort and the time to get good at this craft. And so they're just these lower line guys are just getting rewarded with it here tonight.
Well, all these guys, they played junior hockey at some level, and they want to continue playing into college. This is their opportunity, and of course, it worked out last year for the Illini. Made the national championship game. That's the goal again this year. We'll have a national anthem. We'll be right back. Illini Hockey on YouTube. That doesn't compare in my mind to last night's Jim Cornelius, dude that sung it, but that's always good.
Yeah, I mean, the recording did well tonight. I mean, speakers held together. I mean, can't really say that in previous years, so I mean.
Yeah, good job by the speaker really stepping up its game tonight to make sure
really,
good anthem.
Answering the call tonight.
Well, also looking to answer the call, Donovan Bird, his first career start for the Illini. Last weekend, it was Jake Barnhart and Royce Allred, the freshman out of Texas. Tonight, Donovan Bird, who took 2 years off of hockey and has joined playing hockey again this year. Now he's on the D1 team for the Illini, looking to move into one of those backup roles entering conference play.
Yeah, just trying to help out with the depth for the Illini, too. Usually you want to have about three goaltenders on the roster. Two usually gets the job done, but you never know with injuries when a guy's going to go down and for how long he's going to be out. So having three netminders on the roster really helps out.
Justin Reese, Adam Howie, going to take the faceoff at center ice. The first period, the Illini 3-0. They've scored 24 goals, only have allowed three. Those three came the first game of the season. And Illinois has shut out their opponents the last two games. Illinois State's head coach Bobby DiNardi, Illinois, Nick Fabrini, and we're off. Illinois State wins the faceoff, but goes in the Illinois zone. Ricky Adam pressures, and Evan Sabo with a great keep to try to keep it in the Illini zone, but Illinois State goes back to try to clear. And the neutral ice is Adam Howie. Howie, one of the alternate captains on this Illinois State roster. Held against the boards, and Justin Reese pokes it away. Mark Gandotti now gaining the start, second defensive pairing. Ricky Hadding over the block eye, loses control of his skate and the puck, and has to just clear it all the way down and go back. Illinois goes for the first change, 19:25 left to go.
Yeah, Ricky almost had a burnout right there. I don't know if his skates are tied tightly all the way or what, but he almost went down.
Adam Howie going down the side, and great poke check by Luke Forfar. Able to knock it away and send Andrew Van Dyke back to the right point. Van Dyke shot and a glove save, knocked back away to the point, back to Van Dyke.
Yeah, Van Dyke's a guy you got to watch all night. He's going to get his fair share of shots. He's always looking to put the puck back in that, always looking to be the aggressor for this ISC Redbirds too.
And it's those first two saves, I think, for Diamond Bird that kind of give him that confidence to keep going, especially a nice little glove save. You'd rather see maybe in that case he had the chance to go in the goal line and give up that rebound. Had a few Illini there, but nevertheless.
Yeah, it's always good to get the leather going early on. Just make sure you know it's there, and that's what Donovan Bird was able to do. It's good for him to get a little bit of momentum with making a couple easy saves right off the bat.
Nolan Pass stops it with a skate as Luke Forbar shot on net. It's a different goaltender tonight. It's not Mark Hayden. Instead, it's number 35, Corey Wazalewski, 6'3", out of Crystal Lake. So a little bigger of a goaltender tonight that Illini are going to face. But not much of an issue because they got to Mark Hayden last night.
Yeah, and so that means the Illini are going to have a chance to maybe take more advantage of as we had a deflection there by Bobby Ernsting around the net. But it means the Illini are going to have an opportunity maybe to take more advantage of Wojcicki being 6'3", maybe trying to go 5-hole on him. With Hayden, since he was so since he was a shorter goaltender, it's a lot quicker for him to drop down into the butterfly. As with Wojcicki, he might be more tempted to be
standing
up.
And a shot off
up.
The post. Back to the left point, it's Bobby Ernsting. Over to Joe Nolan. Nolan controls, past the blue line. Ernsting calls for it, but instead goes to number 17, John Moskaluk. 18:30 left to go, 0-0. Illinois won 4-0 in this weekend opener last night. Right point, John Moskaluk. Past the half boards to Ernsting. Back to Nolan. Oh, he can't handle the pass. A little bit too much sauce in that one. It goes all the way back down. And you usually see some. We've seen some crisper passing so far this season from that lineup, but just a little sloppy early on, as that's a great lead pass for Bobby Ernsting to number 18, Casper Ribba. And we've talked about Ribba the past three games as well. He's just been great so far for this Illinois roster.
Yeah, and it just speaks to how talented he is, that he's already on a line with Bobby Ernsting and Luke Forfour, two guys that are probably the centerpiece, a couple of the centerpieces of this Illini team, and Ribba's already on a line with them, so really just goes to show how talented of a player he is.
Yeah, and that line, he's been that since the first game of the season. Corcoran with a shot, another glove save by Donovan Bird. Seen two of those so far in the first 2.5 minutes of the game. Donovan Bird, a little bit bigger of a goaltender, kind of maybe more of a David Eflin, Ross Lippitt kind of build. And how's that maybe change compared to someone that's smaller like Jake Barnhart?
I mean, with Bird, it's just he's going to be a little bit more, he's going to want to come out of the net a little bit more. He's going to use his bigger frame to try to really close off the net from any scoring opportunities. Whereas a guy like Jake Barnhart, he might stay a little bit farther back, because since he's not as bigger, it leaves the net a little bit more vulnerable.
Illinois wins the faceoff, goes all the way back down, now back. Illinois trying to clear it once again. Charlie Salks to Stephen Quinn, neutralized, too far for John Moskaluk. They get sent all the way back down by Illinois State. The Redbirds are able to go for a change. 17:11 left to go in the first period, 0-0 the score. Near side, that's Paul Prigo to the bottom of your screen, another freshman, one of the defensive freshmen. Bill Novosel skating through, and Prigos has it at the left point. Over to Novosel. Novosel passes it along the board. Stephen Quinn looking to be the first one to get to it. He's been that several times so far this season. But with the keep, the attempt, Mark Gandotti not able to save it. And now I have to tag up and go back.
Yeah, Stephen Quinn off to a great start to this season. He has 5 goals in 3 games so far. Had the first goal last night. We'll see if he nets the first one here tonight.
That pass too far to Illinois State's number 9, Matthew Rush, and going another way now is Jack Healy. Healy going down the right side to Kolas. Kolas with a shot blocked away by Wazalewski. Kolas back to the corner. Kandati with a shot, has some traffic in front of him, and Jack Healy tried to go for the low slot redirection, couldn't get to it.
Yeah, we're already seeing Wazalewski not really have as much rebound control as Mark Hayden had last night. He's doing a great job deflecting pucks away with his pads, but he's not really controlling where they're going or covering the puck up so far. Illini might be able to take advantage of that and get some good rebound opportunities.
Kolas used the board for a pass, but it didn't end up working out there. Adam Howie and boards. Pass back out to the left point. It's number 24, Nolan Justad. Had a few nice passes last night. Kavanaugh, the shot wide of Donovan Bird's nut.
Yeah, and there's not going to be too many chances where Van Dyke's going to miss on an opportunity like that. He had a wide open net on Bird's glove side, but he just wasn't able to bury it. Illini catch a break there.
Small sample size in Donovan Bird's Illini career, only 2 periods from last week's game. Didn't allow a single goal against the Spartans. Osasi over center ice, passes it back to their defensive zone. To Van Dyke, he takes a push from Joe Nolan at the blue line, and that gives Illinois, and then a huge hit. That sends number 13, Jack Ram, to the ground. Evan Sabo, shot tipped all the way up into the netting. So 5 minutes in now, 15:12 left to go in the first period. 0-0 the score. Some opening thoughts maybe. Illinois not maybe as aggressive as we saw last night.
Yeah, we're just not seeing it being as clean as they were last night. Some passes just bouncing off the sticks. Doesn't look like they're skating as hard in the neutral zone. Defensively, they've given up some pretty good scoring opportunities for the Redbirds. Donovan Bird looking solid so far in that, helping that out. But Illinois just looking just a tad bit complacent here right out of the gates.
Robert Colada couldn't handle past the blue line. Illinois goes the other way now. Going past one man is Justin Reese. Had a hat trick last Friday to Ricky Haddon. Had a goal last night. Haddon, and it doesn't get past Wazalewski. Almost did. Had to kind of like close up his legs there in the butterfly. And I thought that might have gone through.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, just wasn't able to really get the puck on a stick all the way, so the shot was just kind of a trickler, which it kind of, which can throw a goaltender off. I mean, they think the puck's coming in a lot faster than it is, but it's really just a slow burner.
Evan Sabo off the draw. Can't get it to go. Illinois State attempts to clear. In the neutral ice, number 98, Daniel Sarnecki. Forward out of Bensonville. The pass wide of the net. Kalata can't get to it. Justin Reese behind the net. And Ricky Haddon takes a hit in neutral ice, and it goes all the way down. Illinois goes for another change. 14:30 left to go, 0-0. Illinois has scored 8 first period goals over their 3 games so far. Sarnecki going down to the near side to the goal line. Behind the net now, takes a hit from Paul Prikos, which knocks away the puck. Bobby Ernston going over the blue line, but over the block eye, over the blue. Kasper Ribba into the corner, near side, bottom of your screen in your blind spot. Back to Ribba at the left circle. Great pass to Tyler Opilka, and Luke Forfar was just a second late on that. It would have been a great chance if the puck was where he was.
Yeah, it was also a great block shot by an ISU defender right there to get right in front of Luke Forfar the last second. Unless he would have had a great one-on-one opportunity with Wazalewski.
Yeah, Corey Wazalewski.
Just making sure we got that correct. It's kind of a little tricky name there, but
I think Corey Wazalewski got one of the starts last year also against the Illini here at the Big Pond, so name recognition, you know.
Name recognition.
It's coming along with it.
Luke Forfar had a great opportunity, but there was a great block shot in between them.
Bobby Ernsting behind that gets tipped away. Kasper Ribba chases for it. Ernsting does too. It's that show. It goes to number 21, Max Pushchuk. Good hockey name, Pushchuk. Kasper Ribba tips it back to Luke Forfar. Check that, Tower Opilka. To Kasper Ribba over the blue line. Drops for Ernsting. Ernsting in the left circle. Deeks past the man. Toe drag. Number 22, Tyler Opilka. Opilka, wraparound chance. Mark Gandotti was in front of that and handled the pass. Just couldn't get it off. That would have been a nice shot on Wazalewski if he was able to go far side.
Yeah, we saw him whiff on one of those last night, too. Mark Gandotti really just needs to take that next step in his game. Just make sure to finish plays like that. It's going to let him evolve into a two-way defender for the Illini, which could really benefit them.
Illinois State a lot of quick changes so far tonight as stays in their defensive zone and tipped off the skate. Number 14, the Novosel, who throws a hit at the box down low. But you said last night, Illinois State, they have to bend but not break, and a lot of quick changes so far, not much sustained offense. That's what they seem to be doing early on here in the first.
Yeah, and you want to get quick changes here in the Big Pond just because of this wide eyes. It makes you want to have to skate a lot farther to pucks than you're normally used to. So if your line gets stuck out there for a while, it could be a real advantage for the other team just because of just how tired they could get. And if you get an icing, then all of a sudden the other team has fresh skates on a very tired defense that has to skate in this wide pond.
Illinois State clears it all the way back down. Hybrid icing as they have here at the ACHA level. And 12-12 left to go. That's Eric Fisher. I'm Stephen Cohen. You're watching Illini Hockey on YouTube. Illinois 3-0 so far this season. They beat Michigan State twice last weekend. They took care of the Illinois State Redbirds last night here in this in-state rivalry. They'll meet again 2 more times in Bloomington in February. But the Illini, this is it for the tune-up schedule. They got North Dakota. They're heading to North Dakota to play Minot State in Jamestown next week. The shot from Jack Grab. It's in. It looks like it was off John Moskluk on the rebound, and they got past Wazalewski. 1-0 Illinois, 12:08 left to go in the first.
Yeah, that's what I was talking about with Wazalewski. It looks like he didn't really have quite the amount of rebound control that Mark Hayden had last night. He was letting some pucks bounce off the pads early on, and he wasn't controlling the rebound. And right there, John Moskluk, right place at the right time off a great shot from the blue line from Joe Nolan. So why not get on the board here early on right now? A little bit of momentum to help them carry this over in the rest of this first period. ISU kind of come out and threw a couple first punches at the Illini, which they weren't ready for. Van Dyke had that great scoring opportunity early on, but Illinois, they bounced back here to get the momentum early on. Great goal by John Moskowitz.
1-0, Illinois has the lead. They have 9 first period goals so far this season over 4 games. It's been those quick starts for the Illini that really have kind of been the story so far this season, kind of opened up these games early on. The Illini haven't trailed yet in 2018.
And once again, too, it's the third line that gets that goal for the Illini. They've just been producing all season so far.
How about this, the second line, Thomas Kolas with a shot from his knees, and it's wide. Number 89, Andrew Van Dyke, the shot deflected off Bird, and Thomas Kolas in the right place at the right time, able to knock him back away. He tipped it into his own bench. Had a good chance for maybe a 3-on-2 rush, but he accidental tip.
That's a good save by Bird, but he needs to make sure he works on deflecting that puck behind him instead of in front of him. That's what gives up good scoring opportunities. You saw the puck was just about a couple inches away from getting on a Redbird stick, and he would have had a very good rebound opportunity. So he needs to work on deflecting the puck so the rebounds can't happen. Either that or covering it up, but that's a tough one to make. High blocker, you can't really cover that puck up.
A pair of number 19s on the faceoff, Howie and Healy. And it's won by Illinois State, stays in their zone, but now it's Illinois trying to escape with it. Into the corner, Kavanaugh sends it. And Tower Opilkin out behind that. Opilkin to Richter. Richter tries to clear. No penalties yet so far in tonight's game. All 5-5 hockey. Sent all the way back down. Kandati in the corner. To our right. Now Illini going right to left in this first period. Illinois State left to right. And their black and red uniforms. Now Illini for the second straight night in gray, orange, and blue. 11:04 left to go. The Illini 1-0 lead on John Moskluk's fifth goal of the season. Opilka sends it behind him back to Mark Kandati. And Corcoran. Illinois on the forecheck. Back to Corcoran, number 22. Plainfield Illinois native sends it all the way back down. And Illini able to send Drew Richter off the ice. Yeah, Ricky had him back on. Had a goal last night. Justin Reese takes a hit. He had a hat trick last week. Now it's Mark Kandati with space. Over the blue line. Has a man. And sent back to the outside, near side half boards. Czernecki tried to clear it, but he fell down on the ice and sent all the way back down to them boards.
Not too often that you're going to see Mark Kandati leading the rush there, so it just shows that he's been adding a new level of his game. You saw Joe Nolan last season just be so successful at that. And so if Kandati can also add that, then it's going to make this a very dangerous Illinois line.
Ricky had him with a shot from the high slot on the break by himself. Evan Sabo tried to get the rebound shot, and it's saved by Wasilewski. But it's maybe those rush opportunities that we didn't really see the Illini have last night, where that's one place you still said you want to see them in transition kind of take advantage of those opportunities and improve.
Yeah, and it's just it's also just controlling the pace of the game. If you're getting a rush opportunity one after another, you're just going to eventually tire out your opponents. And the Illini, they're used to skating on this wide ice while their opponents might not be. And so there's going to be an endurance factor in that. So the Illini are constantly coming at their opponent.
Bobby Ernsting from the high slot, the shot wide of Wasilewski's net to his left. Jack Graham back to Ernsting. And now potentially, and he had nobody to beat number 17 Jacob Ambersad, but the lead pass, the stretch pass was too far for him. Shot back, deflected by Joe Nolan. And that's Kasper Ribba. With the pass and neutral ice to Neil Novosel. Novosel, it's a four-far shot very high on Wasilewski's net. Into the corner we go. And Illini takes a hit in the corner. He's down. He gets back up, and now the puck is loose still, fighting for it. The save by Jack Graham, the left point. The shot deflected by number 17, Ambersad. 9 minutes left to go in the first, and an icing call on the Illinois State. But what were you saying? You're finishing up your kind of a phrase there. I cut you off.
Oh, no, you're fine. I mean, we had a play developing, but I was just saying that if you have guys like Mark Andotti can add that rush opportunity part to his game alongside Joe Nolan, who he's paired with, then you're going to have a very offensive-minded defensive pairing that's just going to continue to put more pressure on the defense when they already have to worry about guys like Bobby Ernsting and Luke Forfar. So it's just going to add a whole other offensive aspect to this Illini team that they didn't have last year with Mark Andotti.
Stephen Quinn controls the puck, passes behind him. John Moskluk swipes at it. Illinois State now. Back to Stephen Quinn. At the left point. Puck is loose again at the end boards. Obviously the big ice here, much bigger. And John Moskluk throws a huge hit into the boards.
It's going to be a boarding penalty on John Moskluk.
Yeah, so Illinois State, they send Wasilewski's heading off the ice, and Wasilewski will have to come back on the ice. Illinois State was trying to get that sixth attacker on the big ponds. It won't work, though. John Moskluk said to the box for the first penalty of the game, and Illinois State, the power play for them wasn't that great last night, even though they had a series of opportunities.
No, it wasn't great, but they also I also thought it wasn't bad either. They had good puck movement. I thought they got some good shots on goal, but Jake Barnhart was just sending everything back. But that's just a silly penalty on John Moskowitz. That's a clear boarding penalty. Nothing about it. I mean, you could see the back of his jersey 100%, so you knew right away as soon as he made a hit, that's a boarding penalty. Those are the kind of penalties that you have to erase because those are the ones that are going to cost you when you're playing teams like Jamestown and Minot State.
Kind of that late hit penalty in football, just the play wasn't even developing where Moskowitz was at that point. And
there's just no need for
that hit. Boards. Yeah, no. Illinois, Jack Healy able to clear it, so 1:40 left to go on John Moskowitz's minor for boarding. Wasilewski sends it behind him and gets back in the net. So Illinois, one of the best PKs in the country, entering this weekend 60%.
Also one of the most offensive-minded PKs in the country as well.
Oh, I know. Four short-handed goals last Saturday. A puck, a stick flies in there. He catches it in stride. That shot wide. It was Adam Howie that lost his stick at first. Push check at the point. And the pass down to Howie at the goal line. Donovan Bird moving well laterally. And push check sends it. And that one hits the back of the cage, so it hit the netting. As the Redbird is sent into the end boards, and sent all the way down this time by Thomas Coaz, and we'll whistle. 1:58 seconds left on John Moskowitz's two-man minor.
Yeah, good job by Bird covering up the right side of the net there. You knew right away that's where he was trying to put the puck. And so because of that, because of Bird being able to shut off that right side of the net, it just allowed, that's what caused the puck to go wide there. That's what you have to do. Your goaltender has to be your best penalty killer, and Bird's showing it right there.
Yeah, it's one of those tight angle shots where especially if you cut off the spot on the net where he thinks he can get that shot, makes it even that more difficult. So Donovan Bird doing well so far. Stephen Quinn had a short-handed goal last week, and another premature whistle as that puck was still loose.
Yeah, Wasilewski just whiffed on covering the puck, and Stephen Quinn was right there. He thought he might have had an opportunity maybe to have something. He's been active so far this season. Just Stephen Quinn always seems to be around the puck. And it's just a good start for him, but he's just pretty upset that we got a premature whistle there. Puck was definitely not covered up.
Stephen Quinn got his fifth goal of the season last night. He had three goals all of last season. Just over 30 seconds left on Moskowitz's two-man minor, so Illinois State still with the man advantage. That puck hits Corcoran's stick and neutral ice, and they have to go back and reset. Corcoran, Stephen Quinn, look at that, making his own chance. Send it to Drew Richter. Richter has two men. A little toe drag. He'll just send it back. So Illinois is going to attempt to just kill off the rest of his PK. But look at Stephen Quinn making the moves as a senior now. One of the leaders of this team and showing it with his hustle.
Yeah, he's just out-muscling everyone in ISU. Anytime he seems to be around the puck, he seems like he always ends up getting it.
Wasilewski was diving for that because Drew Richter got back so quickly, he thought Richter was going to have a chance to make a play on it.
I mean, that's a great heads-up play by Wasilewski. A very dangerous play, but
offsides.
He executed it perfectly to make sure Richter didn't have the scoring opportunity. You don't really see that too often.
That is
from
hustle
Goldson.
Between Quinn and Richter. Richter, of course, is very fast. Quinn, not going to say he's flat-footed, but he's not one of the quickest guys in this team. And just the hustle between those two guys, then pressure Wasilewski into those kinds of situations, that's some great play by the Illini's forwards.
Yeah, I mean, Wasilewski, that's a play where you have to know 100% you're going to get that puck, because if you don't,
Cole's going on the right side. Tip pass. Richter with a rebound. The puck is still loose. They can't get to it. No one can get back in the net. Wasilewski was down on his back there, and now he still just gets up. That shot wide by Charlie Salk from the right point. Puck still loose. Prego's the first one to get to it. Shot deflected by Wasilewski. 5:51 left to go. It's back to Salk. Fans lighting here at the Big Bond. And now we're seeing some Baristikov again. Some extracurriculars going on with 5:48 left to go. That was one of Illinois' best chances so far because they're just making Wasilewski look silly on the ice.
Yeah, I mean, he's standing up strong against the Illini, but he can't control the puck at all. About four shots hit him right either in the chest or the pads, but he wasn't able to cover the puck up. Great job on him to make sure to keep the puck out of the net and stand tall. As it looks like we're going to double minors here for Pride for Ruffin.
Yeah, coincidental minors, Matthew Resch and Jack Healy. Jack Healy took a few penalties in his debut weekend with the Illini last weekend. So we'll see some 4-on-4 hockey at the Big Bond. Check that, it's going to be 5-on-5, so we'll see what that call is. I assume to be Quinnsdale Miners.
Yeah, no, it's for roughing. Yeah. I mean, you saw Healy. They were battling in front of the net. And I guess
Casper Ruben doesn't realize right now he has to go off the ice. Illinois State only has four guys. Illinois has five. It's going to be a Luke Forfar.
There we go.
Yeah, there we go.
So we got 4-on-4 hockey here, and we saw the Illini get a goal off that last night. Last season, you saw them thrive in 4-on-4 opportunities because, once again, they just take advantage of this wide ice that their opponents aren't quite as familiar with. They use their speed to their advantage when you got when you're just shorter them in.
1:40 left to go. On the two-minute Quinnsdale Miners for Ruffin, for Rush and Huey.
Offsides
for the Illini. And Bobby Ernstein, the captain of this team, a little on-ice coaching with Casper, but that's what you want to see from these leaders, especially just kind of working with him right now on the ice during the game and making him better.
Yeah, it's still early on, too, so they're probably just talking about building that chemistry and making sure, like, hey, I was going to do this move to get across the ice, so don't cross the blue line yet. And so that's just probably all that was, is just establishing more communication.
Establishing communication, that's a big league term.
Yeah.
We got A-Rod over here.
Nah, let's calm down.
Adam Howie with the puck at the end boards and sent back out to Opilga. Opilga shot wide, deflected of Wasilewski. Just over 5 minutes left to go to the line. I have 1-0 on John Moskowicz's lone goal here in the Saturday night showdown. Casper Ribba trying to put a move on a man and gets the goal line. Net is dislodged. Ribba runs into the net. That must hurt a little bit as there's a whistle for the net. Casper Ribba is, I wouldn't say he's out of control because he makes some great moves right there, maybe a little too much.
That was a great play by him because he drew the penalty right there. It looks like he got hooked a little bit after he's making that deep move. Wojcicki made a great poke check to get that puck away, but because of the series of deke moves that Reba was putting on, he drew a penalty for the Illini. So now they're going to have a 4-on-3 advantage here for a decent while now.
Yeah, Ryan Glennon, the new Lennox native, making a sixth appearance of the season. Heads to the box for 2 minutes for hooking. So the Illini 4-on-3. This is when they absolutely thrive. This is
this is where you have to get a goal if you're Illini.
You got that 2-0 lead. Joe Nolan to Bobby Ernstinger, taking the point back to Nolan, the left circle. Nolan. Move in. There's cross checking for Glenn. Nolan from the point. Wide and high of Wasilewski.
Going for the high blocker there. Just was a little too high.
Ernsting over the pass to Forfar. And blocked all the back away. 35 seconds left on the 4-on-3 until it becomes 5-on-4 again. The Illini's favor.
Yeah, I like that idea there, too, between Ernstein. He saw a 4-4 cross in front of the net, unchecked by any ISU defender. So just good play on him.
Nolan stops at the blue line. Pass down to Ernstein. Tip pass to Nolan.
One too many passes right there.
Yeah, I thought Ernstein should have taken that.
Yep, 100%. I mean, he had a wide-open shot, forehand in front of the net. Just got to take that.
Thomas Kolas heads out on the ice. 10 seconds left. One more rush. Luke Forfar shot wide. And puck is still loose. Forfar. Spins back to Nolan, 2 seconds left to 4-on-3. Back to 5-on-4 now. The Illini still have a chance to get a shot right now. Still the advantage, essentially. And that pass too far for Forfar. So that's what they're trying to do tonight. Set up Forfar, centering him. It just hasn't worked yet.
Yeah, no, they centered him perfectly there. Just Forfar whipped on getting the puck. If he was able to get a handle on that, he would have a great scoring opportunity. As Wozniewski hadn't quite slid over to his blocker side yet, he would have had a decent chance with a little bit of room in the net to put the puck there.
Alongside Eric Fisher, I'm Stephen Cohen. You're watching Illini Hockey on YouTube. Thank you for watching. Make sure to follow us on Twitter, at Illini Hockey, and like us on Facebook, Illini Hockey, for all the latest in-game updates during the week, and also the links to the broadcast streams.
So now we got 5-on-4 penalty power play for the Illini, about 40 seconds left on that.
Charlie Salk paired with Paul Prikos tonight, right now on the ice with Tyler Opilka. Opilka, one of the alternate captains on this team, his third straight year wearing a letter. Pass to Richter, and almost offsides as Richter almost took it too soon. Salk at the right circle. Back to Opilka at the point. Opilka hesitates. Opilka, the slap shot coming. And Wasilewski jumps on that one. You see what Wasilewski's doing now. He knows footsteps are coming.
Yeah.
He hears it.
Well, especially on the power play, too. You know there's an extra foot there and no one there to really check him. Opilka's stick broke on that play, which is why that shot seemed a little lackluster. Just stick snapped in half on him. Walczewski did a good job of making sure that no extracurricular was going to happen after that shot, covering it up right away.
That's not cheap. Those sticks are expensive.
Yeah, I mean, he's also not paying for it too much.
His brother, also, Luke Opilga, is in the St. Louis Blues system out of Effingham, Illinois. So, you know, there's some money.
In the family. Yeah,
got some money now. Drafted back in 2015. 2:48 left to go, 5-on-5 hockey. Goal line pass to Reese. Back to Sabo. Sabo from the left circle, deflected. And nice job getting in front of it. It's number 24, Nolan Justad, to make sure that there's no second chance for the Illini.
That was a great play by Joe Nolan there to stop Howie, who was, looked like he was going to be have a one-on-one with Donovan Bird on the other end. But Joe Nolan did a great job deflecting that puck right by the red line. It actually led to a scoring opportunity for the Illini.
And Joe Nolan at 6'4", 220. He's one of the biggest guys on this ice. He's no Tommy Abrams, as the Illini had 2 years ago. He was about 6'7", 250. But Joe Nolan is big, and he knows how to use a stick.
He knows how to use – he's big, and like you said, knows how to use a stick, especially on the offensive side that he's at, on the ice. He's a great playmaker for his teammates. He knows how to just really create at that blue line point attack area, and he also has a great shot on him too.
We almost saw the shot right there from the left point. Instead, he passes it up to Graham in front, and then now that one hits the back of the cage. Another chance – oh, a diving stop by number 19, Adam Howie, and that would have been a 2-0 game if not.
Yeah, what an amazing play by
Howie, another end. That shot wide of Bird's net. Wow, Adam Howie.
Doing it on both ends so far in that.
Thomas Kolas going through the high slot. The shot, glove saved by Wazalewski. I can't get over that Adam Howie play. He dove in front of Wazalewski and saved that.
Yeah, no, that's just an effort play out of Howie there. And then you saw him, you didn't see him just stay on the other side of the ice and let that play develop. You saw him hop up. And then you saw on the trail and get the shot opportunity there. And so that's just a huge play. There's a reason why there's a letter on his chest. It's because he's making plays like that for the Redbirds.
Adam Howie has played all 7 games for the Redbirds this year. 2 goals, 3 assists, also 1 save. Illinois up 1-0, 2 minutes left in this first period. And Ernsting loses his twig. He doesn't like that play. Doesn't matter. Goes all the way back down behind Bird's net. Paul Pregos with the tip, puts it up in the air, and the poke check away. Goes back to Colada. Colada over to number 18, Chris Jablonski. Jablonski in the corner. And Ernsting has now a chance for a 3-on-2 if they can get it fast enough. They won't. Ernsting over the blue line, back, pass to Pregos, the right circle. Pregos, the shot, tipped up in the air, and goes behind Wazalewski's net. 85 seconds left to go in the first period. The Illini up by 1. It's in their offensive zone. Behind that, Novosel takes a hit at the end boards, and Condotti can't get the save or the keep, so it goes all the way back. They've changed up the lines, per se. It's Condotti and Salk right now. Forward with that shot. Blocker save with the right blocker by Wazalewski going the other way. Now it's number 98, Daniel Sarnecki. Sarnecki going on the right side, and that pass to Van Dyke. Van Dyke circles, spins back, and tries to create some space in the corner. Push check at the goal line. Corcoran calling for it at the bottom of your screen. And tipped away by Bobby Ernsting. 40 seconds left to go. The Illini up by 1. They go for a change.
That was a great block shot by Luke Forfar at the blue line right there. Allow the Illini to clear the puck and get a fresh skates on the ice.
We'll see if that's the last change they go for in this period. 30 seconds remaining. Mark Condotti pass it. Stretch pass. Stephen Quinn can handle it. Goes all the way back down. Mark Condotti at the left point. Another glove save by Wazalewski. So give him credit, though. We're nearing the end of the first. They have bended, but they haven't broke.
Yeah, and Wazalewski's the main reason for that. He started off a little shaky tonight. Just seemed to not really have good vision of the puck early on. But so far after that, he's just really stood tall. He's been flashing that glove so far in the last half of this period. He's made some incredible saves. He also had some help from Adam Howie there to make to keep a goal off the board, but give Wazalewski credit. He's looked great so far tonight.
One last rush. Number 97, Corey Schwartz sends it down behind that. Number 17, Ambrosette. 2-1. It's in neutral ice. That's how the first period comes to an end. So 1 goal, John Moskowitz. The Illini still have never trailed this season, but Illinois State, a valiant effort so far, only down by 1.
Yeah, Illinois State came out this game and were kind of the aggressors early on. Illinois seemed to be seemed to be a little bit of a step behind Illini, and then you saw them find their skates and really start skating and using their speed to their advantage. But Wazowski, he had a great first period, in my opinion. Like I just mentioned, started off a little shaky, but then he really seemed to get comfortable in the net between the pipes, and he made some great saves. Illinois, they came out fast, or they came out slow. They eventually gradually started to get a little bit quicker, and then you saw the goal happen. But if you're Illinois, you have to really wish you had that 4-on-3, or you took more advantage of that 4-on-3 opportunity you had. I mean, those are opportunities you just have to score on, especially against a team like ISU. Give credit to them, though. They really, like you said, Steven, they bended, but they didn't break. And so it's only a 1-0 hockey game heading into the first period.
Yeah, Illinois looking good so far. Donovan Bird and Nets hasn't allowed anything yet. We'll be back in a few minutes. This is Illini Hockey on YouTube.
My name is Danielle Williams with Anthony and Patrick. We're our first. Sorry guys for the technical difficulties, but my name is Danielle Williams with Anthony and Patrick for our first intermission report. We're coming off of a 4-0 win of ISU. I wasn't here yesterday, so would anybody like to give our YouTube audience and radio audience a recap of yesterday's game?
Yeah, so I was here at the game last night, ran the Twitter. So honestly, last game, fairly similar to this one. Illini got off to kind of a slow start, wasn't able to score until the last couple minutes, and they scored two goals in the last 6 minutes, actually 40 seconds apart from each other. So two fantastic goals last night, and it never slowed down from there. They were able to win 4-0 against Illinois State, and it was a great game for the Illini, a great game for Barnhart last night.
They also had their second straight shutout to go with, so they've now gone after the first period of shutout play now. They've gone 8 periods in a row without allowing a goal. So the defense and the offensive line have been really good as of late.
Yeah.
I can't pronounce the ISU's goalie's name, but I know that it's a different goalie from last night and that the goalie is significantly taller than last night's goalie. And I was wondering if you guys thought that, Illinois is taking advantage of the height differences.
Yeah, his name's Wasilewski, and he looks to be a little bit more composed behind the goal. He hasn't been making too many aggressive attempts out of the goal. He's staying kind of put in net. He's staying back a little bit, and I think that bigger body frame is going to allow him to deny some more goals. He also made a little bit of a risky attempt trying to come out of the goal and bat one of the pucks away. He had to leave his feet, but he's only given up one goal, which I think for Illinois State is a good thing.
Yeah.
I noticed that Illinois' offense has been on point, but ISU's defense has kind of been struggling a little bit. The first 5 minutes of the game, for the period, they started off aggressively, but they've kind of lost momentum. What do you guys
ISU's left a lot of lanes open for the Illini. They've been able to run their set plays whenever they really wanted to. Work their way around the ISU defense. To honestly, shout out to Bobby Emstring, who's been absolutely fantastic so far in this game. He's controlling the puck, and he's setting up the plays for the Illini. And some of them haven't converted, but we saw in that one goal that they did score. They were able to convert off of a set piece. So hopefully they'll continue that. And honestly, because of those set pieces, they've been able to connect more on passes and have much better possession in this game than they did in the last one.
I also noticed that with ISU's defense that they definitely need to work more on deflecting the puck when they get the chance. It seems their goalie's taking a lot of hits, but they just kind of let it fly.
Yeah, it has really been a physical game so far. The Illini have came out and hit a lot of the Redbirds today. They've had one boarding penalty and another one that I think could have been called. I think Keeley, it is, number 19, he's been involved in a lot of extracurriculars today, and I think the Illini's physicality is one of the reasons that they're ahead a goal so far.
If you guys had to, I know it's only the first end of the first period, but if you guys had to choose, who would you say are the top three key players of this game?
I'll say the first one. I mean, Donovan Bird, the goaltender, he's already had maybe 5 or 6 saves in that first period, and he's really been kind of star of that defense there, allowing the Illini to have 8 straight periods without allowing a goal.
Yeah, absolutely. I'm going to go on the other side of the puck, and I'm going to go with an ISU player who's been very important for his team. Andrew Van Dyke has gotten the puck a lot. They're trying to work him into the center of the ice. It's been working it fairly well. He fanned on one shot and missed another, but they're going to continue to look to him to try and score for ISU. So Illini defense better pay a little bit more attention to him and making sure he's not wide open in the center of the ice.
And for that third key player, I'm kind of going to take one on both sides. I think Bobby Howie on Illinois State, he had a great save defensively to preserve the one goal deficit. And then he came right back and had a shot right on Donovan Bird's glove at the end of that first period. So I think getting him going a little bit offensively for Illinois State is going to be big. But on the Illinois side, I think Casper Ribba, the outstanding freshman, he needs to get the puck on his stick a little bit more, because whenever he does, good things happen for the Illini.
Before we go into the second period, what do you guys think both teams need to do to step up their game?
I'll answer the Illinois State part, and I'll give it to you for the Illinois part. I think Illinois State has to just generate some more chances. They need the puck in their offensive zone a lot more. I think with a goaltender making his first career start in Donovan Bird, Illinois State has to be jumping all over that. He hasn't started a hockey game in over 2 years. That should feed right into the Illinois State and get them a victory over Illinois.
Yeah, absolutely. You mentioned how little offense ISU's had and how much offense Illini have. The puck is, for the majority of the game, has been on their defensive side for ISU, so that has to change immediately. You can't allow Illinois to dominate you in your own zone. That's going to result in the loss, and that's what we have so far in this game.
Well, thank you for listening to the first period intermission report on WPGU 107.1. Wow. It's been a long time since I've been on air and YouTube. We'll be back in the second period in 3 minutes.
And welcome back, everyone, inside the Big Pond to the Illinois Ice Arena in Champaign, Illinois. It's Illini Hockey on YouTube alongside Eric Fisher. I'm Stephen Cohn. And Eric, it's the second period. The Illini looking to improve to 4-0 in that first period. They look pretty good.
Yeah, I know. Like I said in the first period, they came out a little slow, but once they got the momentum from that first goal from John Mosco, they just ran the rest of the period. You saw them control the puck in their own zone, and then they played clean hockey in the neutral zone, which translated over to very solid scoring opportunities in the Redbirds' defensive zone. They were able to control the puck in that end and make sure they could take advantage of the Redbirds maybe getting a little bit more tired on this wide ice. And so we're seeing the Illini come out here in the second period looking to carry that momentum they acquired late in the first period.
John Mosco got his fifth goal of the season in the first period. Who's going to score here in the second?
Ooh, I'm gonna go Justin Reese. He had a huge weekend against Michigan State, and this third line for the Illini has just been producing all season so far.
Well, Justin Reese wins the faceoff. It gets sent back though to Marcandotti. The Illini going left to right now in the second period. Illinois State going right to left, tipped ahead by Justin Reese, who had a hat trick in the first game of the season, only 3 goals all of last year. That's Andrew Van Dyke. Puck on a stick over the blue line. Stops, starts, Adam Howie. Howie had a save and a shot in the first period. And it's behind the net. And Opoka comes away with it. Alongside Eric Fisher, I'm Stephen Cohn. Thank you for watching Illini Hockey on YouTube. Illini 3-0. Looking to go to 4-0. The shot deflected away from Corey Wasilewski. Tower Opoka's shot. Opoka, the senior from Effingham, Illinois. All the way down. Tipped in by number 10, Connor Brosasi. Jack Graham behind net. And chipped all of the way down, but Evan Sabo might be the first one to get to it. He will not, and it will be icing.
Yeah, and you saw him chip that puck. He thought Evan Sabo was a little bit farther behind the defense than he was, actually. And we're actually going to see a penalty on the Redbirds here, so possibly a holding on Sabo. A penalty for holding Sabo on that, maybe.
Yeah, Connor Bosasi, who had the missed shot on the offensive end, gonna be sent to the box for 2 minutes. Bosasi out of Libertyville, Illinois. At 6 foot, 185. Joe Nolan, Casper with a slap shot, deflected, left blocker. Wasilewski. Nolan back to Casper Ribba. Ribba at the right circle. Over to Nolan, tip pass to Ribba. Back to Nolan, Nolan with a shot from the point, deflected. All the way across to Ribba in the near side corner. Two-minute penalty for checking for Connor Brosasi. And that's Kolas. 1.5 minutes left on the PK. On the power play for the Illini. Goal line pass. Number 44, Luke Forfar. Back to Forfar. Left circle. Shot wide of Corey Wasilewski. And it's sent all the way back down across the boards. That was a hard shot by Luke Forfar.
And we're seeing solid puck movement from the Illini so far. It's going side to side, keeping the penalty killers shifting on their skates. They just haven't been able to generate any really solid scoring opportunities on this power play.
Joe Nolan was going down the right side. Now that's Bobby Ernst thing settle in. Casper, if he was able to get the puck on his stick, it would have been a great chance for an open net. Back down to Donovan Bird, who plays it out, and that 50 seconds left on the power play, and a huge hit by Bobby Ernst thing, sending number 92 Crosley Duckman into the board. John Mosco got the Illini's lone goal in the first period, the first game this season. They scored less than 2 in the first opening frame. And that's into the netting. So 31 seconds left. Illinois, they're not having gotten that many shots though on this power play.
No, they're getting good puck movement, but they're just not getting, they're not transitioning that into solid shots on goal so far. Wasilewski's made a couple solid saves, but he's also given up some pretty good rebound opportunities. We saw right there, I mean, Reba could knock that puck down, he would have had a wide open side of the net there, and that would have been a 2-0 lead for the Illini. He just wasn't able to control it.
Tower Opoka at the blue line, pass to Richter, back to Opoka. Opoka shot, and it was loose in front of the net. Stephen Quinn dove for it, and it goes back. 15 seconds left in the power play. Tower Opoka shot from the point, deflected away. Far side, Charlie Stahl, half boards. John Moskowak going toward the blue line, back to Opoka. Maybe one more shot for the Illini. Opoka, the Drew Richter, back to Opoka. Opoka settles, shoots it on, looking for a deflection. Stephen Quinn with a chance, and Stephen Quinn now, and Corey Wasilewski giving it to him. Quinn throws it now with Colada. And the refs have to separate this, but Stephen Quinn also, he's been great so far in offense, but he can also be that aggressor, even at unnecessary times.
Yeah, he's well known to see his time in the penalty box for the Illini, especially within the last couple of seasons. Stephen Quinn just someone that's such a competitor, always going hard all the time. And, I mean, you saw right there on a simple play like that, he was just bumping around. He bumped Wasilewski, which caused the ISU Redbirds to retaliate a little bit. And we saw even Wasilewski get in there and throw a couple jabs at Steve Quinn. Now we're going to see Quinn head to the box.
Yeah, Stephen Quinn, 36 penalty minutes last season that led the Illini. And now he heads back to the box, probably goalie interference. And, you know, that's one area where Stephen Quinn, if he's going to be such an offensive threat, he's got to control himself maybe in those situations as well.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, that's just a terrible penalty by Stephen Quinn there. I mean, your team has momentum in this second period. You guys were just getting all sorts of shots on goal on Wasilewski. And then it's just a bad penalty. You get overly aggressive and you take a couple of cheap shots at Wasilewski and some of the Redbirds, and they're going to throw you in the box.
Coincidental minor also, so they're going to give Corey Wasilewski for his retaliation on Stephen Quinn's push. He's going to get a two-minute minor, so they will send a Redbird to the box. It looks like it's number 17, Jacob Ambersad, for 2 minutes. So we're going to have 4-4 hockey once again. So Stephen Quinn maybe bailed out because Corey Wasilewski retaliated in that situation. Well, I don't know if I even want my goalie maybe throwing punches or starting to attack other guys.
I mean, definitely not, because they would have had a 5-on-4 power play there. Wasilewski didn't retaliate. But sometimes it's always the person that retaliates that gets penalized. So luckily for the Redbirds, it wasn't that case scenario. The instigator also received a penalty.
Luke Forfar with space shot going glove side. Sticked away.
That was such a great save by Wasilewski, too.
Another chance. That one hits the cage. That was Joe Nolan.
That puck was perfectly placed by Forfar.
But Luke Forfar going toward the low slot, takes a hit, and we will have a penalty now. So that's number 24. Nolan's just that. He's going to go join Ambersad in the penalty box. And 4-on-3 hockey now for the Illini.
Yeah, I talked about at the end of that first period how the Illini were really wishing they could take back that 4-on-3 power play they had and convert. Well, they're going to have that opportunity right here. The Illini on their last 4-on-3 power play just didn't generate enough shots on goal. The puck was moving well, but everyone was a little bit complacent and holding on to the puck a little too long. They need to get bodies in front of Wasilewski, because right now he's just standing very tall. He's having a great showing so far, so they need to get bodies in front of him and just get some deflections if they want to convert on this 4-on-3 opportunity.
Nolan just had his 8th game of the season, 4 penalty minutes now to his name. Kasper Ribba, 4-on-3 for the Illini. Joe Nolan at the point, sends it back to Ernsting. Ernsting to Nolan, left circle shot, hits the back of the cage. Back to Nolan, to Ernsting. Ernsting at the point, back to Nolan, a little fake pass. Nolan, Ernsting, two-man game. Ernsting, looking for a shot, looking for a deflection from Luke Forsberg. Forsberg goes down, and they want to have about 1 minute left on a 4-on-3.
Yeah, Forsberg was there, perfectly positioned. He just kind of got tripped up a little bit and wasn't able to get the puck on his stick for an opportunity.
Tipped away by Ambersad. Ambersad not in the penalty box, as I said before, and Bird sticks it away. So does Joe Nolan. Illini with a chance now. 45 seconds left on the 4-on-3. John Moskowitz ahead at the blue line. Has one man to beat. Shoots it on. Great save by Wasilewski with the 5-hole.
You just saw, I mean, just how much power that Moskowitz has on this.
A lot of one-on-one with Opilka.
You saw how much power Moskowitz has on that stick. He barely even put anything behind that, and that was a dart to Wasilewski. Great save by him.
How about Kalata in the back check? Trying to stop Kasper Ribba, and then Ribba still gets a shot off. Wasilewski able to make the save and stop it. So 15-20 left to go, and the Illini skating quick right now on the ice.
And we're getting a line change now. We're seeing Drew Richter come onto the ice. Premature horn that we just got here at the ice arena. But Drew Richter coming onto the ice. John Moskowitz there. Thomas Kolas, Tyler Opilka. Very dangerous line that the Illini has put out here. But Wasilewski, once again, he's been the best penalty killer for the Redbirds here tonight. Did a great job of covering up that puck and great job of controlling where the rebound's going so far.
Opilka, the Illini win the draw to Opilka. Far side to Richter. Richter at the left circle skating. Wasilewski, another save. He is
flashing
doing great
the glove
right
again
now.
So far.
Yeah, I don't know what. Like, between Mark Hayden and him, like, they have kept Illinois State in the games all weekend. Because they haven't scored yet, but their goaltenders have done a nice job of limiting Illinois at 5 goals total.
Yeah, and if you're Drew Richter, I mean, you have a wide open net, but you also want to take that shot when you have guys in front of it, too. Oh, and he burns out.
Oh, that would have been a great chance again. Like, that was the puck movement you're talking about. That was a quick pass to Opilka and then back to Richter. Now, Kolas. Oh, and
he couldn't handle it either right away.
Yeah, and Sarnacki got in front of that, so a little scared him a bit.
Great
shot by Richter, yeah. So now that that kills off the 4-on-3 back to 5-on-4 for the Illini for 22 seconds, but Nolan Justad still serving that two-minute cross check. 14:45 off the O. The Illini one goal tonight. That's John Moskaluk, who has the puck right now. Moskaluk skating into the corner, sends it all the way around the boards. Opelka, far side on boards, and there will be a delayed penalty now again.
That was in our blind spot.
And Donovan Bird does not realize it right now. The Illinois bench, all of them are yelling for Donovan Bird to get off the ice. He does not realize it, and he finally does. It's too late. If Donovan Bird gets off it quick enough, the Illini might have 5 seconds of a 6-on-4.
Yeah, potentially. I mean, it would have been a 6-on-5 in that situation. So just a first career start, so just a little bit behind on that. I mean, it didn't really play that much of a factor because the Redbirds able to get the puck right away. And so Illinois, they're going to have another chance at the power play. It hasn't really worked out so far for them tonight. I mean, they haven't been able to convert on 2 4-on-3 power plays, which I'm sure Illinois head coach Nick Fabrini just finds unacceptable for the Illini.
Yeah, and I don't think Fabrini is also going to like Bird not being aware of the situation in that case, because if this is a CSCHL game and you have that chance, maybe get that 6-on-5 for a few seconds, you need to take it because you don't know what can happen with that extra attacker on the ice. But Bird unaware at that moment. And now we go back to a 5-on-4. 2 minutes for slashing for Max Pushchek out in Naperville for Illinois State. Far side, Ernsting, goal line pass to Forsberg. Back to Ernsting. Now to Nolan, near side, the right circle. The play, it's wide.
Went for the deflection there. That's why you saw that kind of shot. He was aiming for Luke Forsberg down by the red line to get a deflection.
There's Forsberg, the goal line, trying to center it and get that deflection to Kasper Erba. Nolan takes a slap shot. Ernsting, the shot. Another great save, this time by number 7, Mike Cavanaugh. He's able to tip that one away.
Yeah, Wazowski was able to deflect it away, and then Cavanaugh was able just to clear the puck right afterwards.
And Cavanaugh clears this time. Ambrosette, only one man to beat it. 2-on-1 for Illinois State. That's Jacob Ambrosette, the shot and deflection. And that net is dislodged. Diamond Bird does a nice job of standing tall. Got some help from his defense. Evan Sabo goes down slow to get up. And Illinois State avoids a 2-on-1 break where Illinois State could have tied the game.
Yeah, that was Thomas Kolas. He did a great job, a great diving poke check to make sure that pass couldn't get through. And then he paid the ultimate price by running right into the net. We'll shake it up, but I mean, he's a hockey player, so he'll be fine.
Yeah, check that. I said Evan Sabo, that was Thomas Kolas skating into the end boards after the net was dislodged. 13:30 left to go. 1 minute left on Max Pushchek's minor for slashing. That's number 44, Robert Colada, the captain of this Illinois State team. Behind the net now, behind his own net, is Joe Nolan with the puck. Nolan, a sophomore, he throws it into neutral ice, and Illini near side with it at the bottom of your screen. That's John Moskaluk, who loses it, and it's sent all the way back. 13 minutes left to go in the second period. The Illini up 1-0. It's a 4-4 over the blue line. Only one man ahead of him. Circles back and drops it for Kasper Erba. Erba at the goal line. Back to 4-4. 4-4 with a shot deflected by Wazalewski.
Wazowski doing a great job of staying down in his butterfly there so he could deflect that puck away. Wasn't standing up at all to make sure not to give up the 5-hole.
Salk at the right circle loses the puck. And that shot by Kasper Erba stopped by Wazalewski. So 12:31 left to go. 7 more seconds on Max Pushchek's minor for slashing. And they want to have an offensive zone draw.
Yeah. See, another premature horn out here. I don't know who's hitting the buzzer so far, but not really something you see too much here at the ice arena, just random horns going off. But the Illini, once again, doesn't look like they're going to convert on this power play either. That's something you want to hopefully get cleaned up when you're heading into conference play, especially come huge weekend up ahead. So 0-for-2, 4-on-3 power plays and not doing great as a whole so far. That's something that just unacceptable probably for head coach Nick Fabrini.
Wraparound chance for Drew Richter is taken away by Illinois State's defense. And the shot by John Moskaluk looking for his second goal of the game is taken away as well. The Illinois State 50% on the power play last week against Michigan State. Only one power play goal so far this weekend. Nice defensive play by that line, including John Moskaluk in front of that pass too far. Stephen Quinn will have only one man to beat. That's Mike Wazalewski. Corey Wazalewski, that shot wide of Wazalewski. Behind that now goes all the way back down, and all the way it's going to be icing on the Redbirds. Once again, Stephen Quinn making his name known on the ice. That shot just bad.
Yeah, you saw him kind of turn on the jets there too. As soon as he saw that puck just skating down the ice, he turned up, I would have liked to see him pass that puck off to John Boswick on that 2-on-1 opportunity, but still not a bad shot by him nonetheless. He's just been so active here this season. He seems to always be around the puck, Steven.
Yeah, personally, I like it better when you do the extra pass maybe in that situation, because taking it by himself, he still has one man to kind of beat the on the defense, but if he gets a John Moskowick, you bring the second man into it, it's tougher to defend. 11:45 left to go to the Illini, up by one. It's in the corner. It passed around at the end boards. It hits off Ricky Haddon, who has a pair of goals, a few goals already this season as well. That's Evan Sabo. Sabo passed to Haddon and tries to center it, but Haddon taken away. Ryan Glennon runs into him. That's Glennon now. Takes a hit from Sabo in the middle of the ice. And Justin Reese pressuring Adam Howie. Howie going down the far side, right side. That's falls into the boards. Yeah, that'll be a delayed penalty right now. So Corey Wasilewski gets off the ice fast. And that'll bring a sixth skater on at the blue line. It's a save by Glennon. All the way back down, number 10, Connor Bosasi. That shot's centered, and it's going to go all the way back down. So Illinois.
Got to worry about the puck sliding into your own net there for a second.
Yeah, that's something Ryan Glenn didn't think he'd have to think about. And it's still 6-on-5, so Illinois State. Illinois just trying to touch the puck, and they still can't. Finally, almost they do. Justin Reese somehow couldn't touch that. And now we got Joe Pirelli in for the first time this weekend. Joe Pirelli going down near side to Adam Howie. Howie at the far side and near in the corner now. Bottom of your screen, behind that pass. Illinois finally touches up. That was about 30 seconds of 6-on-5. And that all started because Corey Wasilewski got out of his net fast enough and got to Illinois State's bench.
Yeah, also a little bit different situation on the other end so just not a great penalty by the Illini there. I think it was Justin Reese that tripped up Howie on that left wing side. He just was, Howie got a step ahead of him a little bit, and then Reese just tried to make up for it by sliding, and he caught Howie as a result. Now it's going to be heading to the box.
Yeah, dangerous play for Howie as well, sliding basically head first into those end boards, and those are not forgiving at all in that situation going full speed. 2 minutes forward, tripping for Justin Reese. That'll take the line down to about 8.5 left to go in this second period. Right now, 10:20 left. They're up by one. Illinois stay with the puck, and they're off in the zone. Daniel Sarnecki with it at the left circle, looking for Jacob Ambersad, and he would have had him, but there were several Illini really clouding the middle of that ice, making that a tough pass.
Yeah, it was a great poke check by Joe Nolan there just to break that play up.
Nolan all the way back down. Luke Forfar the first to get to it. Now the Illini have a chance in their offensive zone. Forfar and held against the boards, kind of pinned by Mike Cavanaugh. And Forfar now and Cavanaugh exchanging words, skating back down the ice.
Yeah, he was looking for a holding penalty there.
How about Jablonski? The chance, that won't get past Bird. Illinois State about two chances, they couldn't get anything, and dropping a stick is Chris Jablonski.
Yeah, Bird making his two best saves of the night right there, just standing tall, covering up that left side, and making sure to deflect that puck away with the pad.
And Illinois gets it all the way back down, so they're able to finally get a change now. 40 seconds left, is about a 75-second shift for that first line on the PK. Andrew Van Dyke, takes pass one. Behind them now. Potential wraparound chance. The shot, number 97, Corey Schwartz knocked away. And who else? Stephen Quinn getting involved, has a chance. One man on the short end of break. Wasilewski not able to jump on that. So Wasilewski, we've seen him on all fours several times tonight. And again, Stephen Quinn creating his own one-man fast break shorthanded.
He just bullied through two people to get to that puck. He looked like he took a shot up high in the head, but it didn't matter at all. I mean, you saw his helmet kind of get bumped up a little bit, but he still had an idea where the puck was. And he's just, like I keep saying, Stephen Quinn is always around the puck, always making the right play so far here tonight, besides that penalty that he committed early on in the second period.
Jack Healy loses the offensive zone draw, so 15 seconds left on the Illinois State power play. It's Justin Reese in the box. Andrew Van Dyke over the blue line. Drops it back for Schwartz. Schwartz with 5 goals on tonight's game, making it look at 6. He gets it! Corey Schwartz has 6th goal of the season. The first Illinois State goal of the weekend. It's 1-1 with 8:43 left to go in this game.
Yeah,
second period.
That was an unfortunate play for the Illini there. The shot gets deflected off one of their own defenders, I believe, and sneaks right past Bird's right pad. So just like that, we have an even hockey game, Steven. Illinois wasn't able to convert on several power play opportunities before that, and now just when you thought game felt like Illinois was dominating, and then just like that, it's all squared away at one.
Yeah, and this could definitely be a trap game for the Illini. Maybe looking ahead to next weekend in that case, but also this matters for the rankings. The Illini right now on top of the CSCHL in terms of their rankings at number 3. And a loss today would certainly hurt their cause. Tied at 1, 8:30 left to go. There were 3 seconds left on that Illinois State power play, and they were able to convert with the goal by Corey Schwartz, his 6th of the season. Tipped up, knocked down Casper Ribba. Now it's Ryan Glennon, and Luke Forfar steals it back, pokes away. Micah Young, in neutral ice. The Illini maybe just trying to slow down this tempo now. It's not even favoring them. Illinois State with all the momentum. Just over 8 minutes left to go. That pass too far for Luke Forfar. And stays neutral ice. Bobby Ernston can't get to it. Right now, Illinois State's controlling the puck.
Yeah, I mean, they're just playing clean. They're playing clean in the neutral zone so far. They're not turning the puck over, and they're just making clean passes. And it's transitioning over into the Illini defensive zone. And if you're the Illini right now, you might. It's going to be interesting to see maybe Nick Fabrini take the time out here to try to help bring his team together, because right now they're not playing efficient, clean hockey.
Alongside Eric Fisher, I'm Stephen Cohn, the Illini, in a situation they haven't been in since the middle of March 2018, tied in a hockey game or behind. They had the lead in the first 3.5 games this season. Illinois State has tied it up at 1 on the goal from Corey Schwartz. Illinois looking to take the lead once again. This is Illini Hockey on YouTube. It's live. It's October 6th, 2018. Ricky had another goal line. Tip back for Sabo. Sabo behind the net. Wraparound chance. Passed it back to Jack Graham at the right point. Graham skating. Back to Sabo. Sabo whiffs at it. And stays in their zone. Justin Reese, good second chance opportunity he creates. And Ricky Haddon, the first to get to the puck in the corner, has good position on it. Haddon to Reese. Reese, Sabo, he's trying to center it to him. Stays in the Illini zone again. Jack Graham puts a shot on. Wazlewski finally has a shot at, but this is all because Justin Reese was able to make a nice second play on the puck, and now it's going to stay in their offensive zone.
Yeah, it's just those little things like that. Just making sure to always be around the puck and poking at it when you have a chance, maybe disrupt the other team a little bit. And like you just said, Justin Reese able to create several scoring opportunities with this team just because of a little poke check that he had on the right wing.
Donovan Bird had not all the goal for his first 3.5 periods in his Illini career until that goal by Corey Schwartz out of Wooddale. And now it's 1-1, and Royce Allred, the backup tonight. Thrown all the way ahead by Schwartz. In the corner, it's Neil Novosel. Novosel tries to clear it. He won't. Deflected, though, Tower Opilka. That pass too far ahead for Stephen Quinn, who once again had another great chance for a potential 2-on-1. Amber's out. Stretch pass too much for Mike Cavanaugh. So Polka to Moskva. Moskva can neutral ice over the red, over the blue. And we're gonna have an offsides call. Illinois is gonna go for a change with 6:25 left to go. And what needs to change? What, going into the third period, 6 minutes left, what do you need to see from the Illini toward the end of the second period?
I mean, they've been generating solid scoring opportunities against Wazlewski. He's just standing tall right now. But I want to see the Illini top line generate a little bit more. We haven't really been talking about Bobby Ernsting or Drew Richter or Thomas Kolas this game, really. It's been all Stephen Quinn or Justin Reese so far. So if you're the Illini, you gotta want more production out of your top lines.
Especially that defense as well. We heard so much about how this defense is full of offensive-minded defensemen. They haven't picked up the scoring load yet this year. That's Drew Richter. You just mentioned him. He needs to get it going. And that shot deflected away by Wazlewski.
Great save by Wazlewski. Just making sure to deflect that puck with the blocker off to the far board so no rebound opportunity can generate.
How about a nice save by Donovan Bird, who knocks that one against the end boards. To Van Dyke with some space to high slot. Goes back to the point and intercepted by Thomas Kolas. Drew Richter, Kolas. That's Richter. Pass to Jack Healy. Healy tries to go top shelf. The rebound allowed at first by Wazlewski. And now Thomas Kolas getting into it with a Redbird. So Kolas and Quinn, both of them, we've seen them kind of have some extracurriculars tonight. That needs, in my mind, I don't know, I don't like that.
Yeah, no, and they're just probably a little frustrated right now just because they're in a tied hockey game with ISU at the moment. And their top lines haven't really been producing. Now we're going to see Thomas Kolas head to the box as a result of him just seems just like frustration, but it looks like it's going to be coincidental, actually. Coincidental minors for the two. Van Dyke's heading to the box. So 4-on-4 hockey. Why not thrive on it here at the Big Pond?
You keep saying that. I haven't seen that goal yet, though, in 4-4 tonight.
They scored in 4-4 last night, so that's what I'm kind of going off about. In last season, they were very productive.
They also scored four shorthanded goals last week. We haven't seen those yet either. So
it's not going to happen. Stop. It's never going to happen again.
Going to talk it into existence. Four shorthanded goals in one period, including two by John Moscook last Saturday night in Illinois' 10-0 win over the Michigan State Spartans. Of course, Michigan State Division II, Illinois State Division I in the ACHA club hockey realm. So, Illinois, that was much more of a tune-up last weekend. This weekend, though, Illinois still looking to get those two wins. Improved to 4-0 before three games next weekend. Remember, good save by Jack Graham at the blue line. Graham to Ernsting, Ernsting to the point. Ernsting, Bobby Ernsting, another nice save by Corey Wazalewski. He's been great.
He's been solid. He's had great vision in the puck all night, which has allowed him to control the rebounds here in the second period. He's been flashing the glove so far really well. He's been getting down low in the butterfly, kicking the pucks away. And he's also made some great saves at the block. He's Corey Wazalewski just doing it all here in the second period.
Makes you think why Mark Hayden started last night. It seems like to me Corey Wazalewski is the top goaltender on this Illinois State team.
Yeah, but a lot of those goals last night for Hayden were not his fault. There was one bad one that he let up against Evan Sable, but besides that, he had a great showing himself.
Rimba, the right point. A pass. Ernsting's on the ground. Joe Nolan has the shot, and it's deflected away. Tried to center for Bobby Ernsting, and the puck was just too far on his backhand. It goes all the way back down to Donovan Burry. Tips it away to Jack Graham. 1:12 left on the Coincidental Miners for Thomas Kolas and Andrew Van Dyke. 4:35 left to go here in the second period at the Big Pond. Pass to Jack Graham at the blue line. Over to Joe Nolan. Nolan and Graham, that top defensive pairing this season for the Illini. The pass, the shot. A nice shot by Casper Ribba.
Yeah, Wazowski was actually preparing for the shot from Bobby Ernsting, but Ribba just kind of intercepted that and took his own, which kind of caught Wazowski out of position a little bit, but he makes an excellent save with a left pad.
Kavanaugh calling on the trailer, and he would have had it if it was a good pass because Bird was looking the other way on the weeks on the strong side. And under 4 minutes to go now, that pass to Casper Ribba. Has some open space, goes past one man on the backhand, and to the goal line. Circles back. Illinois goes for a change. Ribba will as well. That shot wide and deflected by Wazalewski. And it's back on the near side, number 8, Jake Harris. Illinois 1 goal in the first period. Illinois State 1 goal in the second period. That's the score in today's game. Drew Richter behind the net. That pass, Luke Vorbar. A great save by Wazalewski. Another great save.
Gosh.
Corey Wazalewski. Oh, my. No way!
Two just amazing saves by Wazalewski. First one, Drew Richter just right in front of the net. Wazalewski practically jumps out to make the glove save. And then he has the presence of mind to stick with the play, get back up to the point where he could deflect away the second scoring opportunity from Drew Richter with the body, and then covers it up perfectly. He's just playing out of his mind, Steve. This is one of the best goaltending performances I've seen in a while.
Unbelievable, Corey Wazalewski. I thought Luke Farfar was definitely going to give the Illini the lead. My gosh. It's still 1-1. Tyler Opilka, New Troyes. Can't get over that save. Paris
that
saves.
Was ridiculous.
He's your first start of the game right now, definitely.
Oh, without a doubt.
Oh, yeah, you don't see many great goaltending performances like this at the ACHA Division I level, but Illinois had a few good ones. Illinois State has a good one tonight. John Moskowitz gained over the blue line to the corner. To the goal line, passed around the boards. Opilka chases for it. He's the first one to get to it. Passes on the backhand. Into the boards, goes Neil Novas, though. Under 3 minutes to go now in the second period, it's tied at 1. Andrew Van Dyke, that's 5-on-5 hockey again. That coincidental minor with Van Dyke and Kolas has come to an end. Illinois State goes for a change. John Moskowitz waiting for the blue one. It goes to Stephen Quinn. Back to Moskowitz now at the right point. Moskowitz the shot. Glove save. Corey Wasilewski.
That's an easy one for him. That's probably one of the easier saves that he's made in a while here. I mean, still can't get over those saves by Corey Wasilewski. Just the presence of mind to get back up and stay with the play, then cover up the puck on the when you know the rebound shot's coming. And then he makes an easy save with the glove there. He had complete vision of it 100% and just covers it up, and now we got a face-off.
Sorry about those technical difficulties where the camera went out for about 3 seconds. We are back now. Illini Hockey on YouTube alongside Eric Fisher. I'm Stephen Cohn. 2:22 left to go in the second period. The Illini and Illinois State Redbirds tied at 1. Charlie Salk has the keep at the blue line. Justin Reese. That's time. That's Colada. Colada gains his own. They passed all the way in. Bird catches it like an outfielder. And it's going to be an offensive zone draw for the Redbirds. And this is finally a chance for him to maybe set up some offense and take that go-ahead goal.
Yeah, these last 2 minutes of the second period are going to be crucial for both sides. Who's going to grab the momentum heading into the third period? So far, ISU has all the momentum right now. They've been, while Wojcicki is making some great.
And there's a chance to take the lead, and it's deflected away. Jablonski's shot.
Bird probably making his best save of the night right there. Stood up tall and kicked that puck away with his left shoulder.
Justin Reese. Reese over to Sabo. Sabo takes a hit at the blue line. And puck stays neutral ice. Reese and Sabo fight for it with an Illinois State defender. It's finally in Illinois' offensive zone, but they don't have control of it. And the first one to get to it, though, is Paul Prigos. Prigos gains his own. He tries to poke at it. And we're going to have a penalty. Looks like it's going to be on a Redbird.
Looks like a potential hooking penalty, I want to say.
Yeah, it looks like number 92, Crosley Duckman, is going to be heading to the penalty box. Check that. It's going to be Robert Colada.
This is a perfect situation for Illinois right now. They have an opportunity to get momentum heading into the third period. They'll have about 30 seconds, if they don't score here in their second period, they'll have about 30 seconds in the third period of 5-on-4 hockey. So then, right now in the second period, what I'm looking for the Illini to do is just get a little bit more movement on the power play and get a lot of shots on goal. That way that kind of momentum and mentality can kind of carry over into the third period.
It's going to be Bobby Ernsting and Corey Schwartz on the faceoff. This 2-minute power play for the Illini. If they don't score, it will take them into the third period. There's 1:29 left to go in the second. The Illini have also scored in every period so far this season. 25 goals over 11 periods. Essentially only over 10. Haven't scored yet here in the second. Illinois State has. They tied it up. That shot deflected away by Wasilewski. We've seen a lot of those tonight. Goes back to neutral ice. Joe Nolan has to go back and retreat. Nolan to Ernsting, the captain of this Illini team. Ernsting at the left point. Stops. Pass to Nolan at the point. Nolan tries to center it. I think he was trying to fake out Wasilewski a bit though there and get a redirect from Luke Forfart.
Yeah, I'm sure Nolan wasn't really intending for that puck to get through all the way. I don't think Wasilewski was either. I think he was playing for the deflection just like Nolan, but that puck gets through and Wasilewski easily kicks it away.
Illinois just trying to clear the puck right now, but Adam Howie with an aggressive forecheck. And Bobby Ernsting with some space. In the high slot, the shot wide and high of Wasilewski's cage. And thrown all the way ahead by the Redbirds, all the way at Donovan Bird. So 30 seconds left here in the second period, and the Illini tied at 1. I don't think anyone saw this kind of performance coming right now. Rebo sends it to the corner. John Moskluk fights for it with Stephen Quinn and Mike Cavanaugh. Quinn at the goal line. Joe Nolan, the slap shot coming and deflected away. Once again by Wasilewski. 5 seconds left. Howie chases. Salk will just hold on to it. 3-2-1-0. That's how the second period comes to an end. So entering the third period, the final 20 minutes of tonight's game, it's 1-1 between the Illinois Fighting Illini and the Illinois State Redbirds.
Yeah, this game's kind of get the feeling of a trap game here so far for the Illini. We talked about how in previous seasons the Illini have kind of struggled on these Saturday night games against opponents like these, coming out a little complacent, a little flat, and that's what they kind of did at the start of the first period, and they kind of came out flat in the second period, and the Redbirds took full advantage of that, even this game up 100%. And so far, Corey Wozniak keep putting together an amazing performance here tonight, making a beautiful save one after another. He had two incredible saves on Drew Richter in that second period. Drew Richter was right in front of Wozniak. He was basically leaping out in front of him to make the glove save. And then he had the presence of mind to stick with the play, get back up, and cover up the puck on the other rebound opportunity. So he's putting together a heck of a night. But the Illini on the power play, they're from what I saw so far in that first minute 30, they're moving the puck a little side to side. Bobby Arntzen had a great opportunity. The puck just was a little too high. He was going high blocker on Wozniacki. And so heading into this third period, Illini might have a little bit of momentum up because of this power play.
Hey, well, it's a little more fun than last Saturday's game when the Illini took it 10-0 for Michigan State. So 20 more minutes of hockey in the Illini, looking for that fourth win. Illinois State's looking for win number three. We'll be right back. It's Illini Hockey on YouTube.
We'll be right back. Ladies and gentlemen, we are back after two periods of play. The Illini and the Redbirds of Illinois State are deadlocked, 1-1. What'd you guys think of that second period of play?
Rough period, really, for the Illini in this one. They weren't able to capitalize on anything. They looked a lot more sluggish, weren't able to connect on as many passes. Defense didn't look like they were able to clear the puck very well in this one. Not able to get the puck back. ISU had a lot of opportunities, and they scored on one of them.
I think for ISU's point of view, they've done a lot better job in the first period. They're capitalizing on the Illini's mistakes. Illinois' lack of discipline is definitely affecting them, and Illinois is just taking that up. I mean, ISU is just taking that up.
Yeah, Patrick, you mentioned the word sluggish. I actually wrote down in my notes here, sloppy. That period was a lot of penalties from both sides, but ultimately the Illinois State Redbirds scored one goal and held the Illini scoreless. After 11 periods of play this entire season, that was the first period all year that the Illini have not scored. What do you think that says about this team?
Not so much as it says about the team, as it just says how bad that period was. I'd like to see a little bit more opportunities from some of the captains, especially in Luke Forfart. We honestly thought I saw it hopefully get going in this game. He did in the last game. Hopefully he comes out and has a much better third period as he does the second period. But other than that, the Illini team's got to get back. Goaltending, maybe not as good as Barnhart was last night. But, you give up one goal in two periods, you're in the position to win the game. That's where the Illini are right now.
I think off of that, I think Bobby Ernsting has also been having a pretty good game, regardless of how his team is playing.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, I agree. Bobby Ernsting's been everywhere on the ice. After that period of play, we are tied 1-1. That is the first tie that isn't 0-0 the Illini have had all year. What do you think that says about the Illini's team, and how do you think they come out in the third period to try to break that tie?
Yeah, well, I think, it's said a lot in sports. The best defense is a good offense. That's what the Illini are going to need, because the Illini offense in this last period was absolutely atrocious. You saw the first play. We complimented them a lot. A lot of their connect-on passes, maybe not in the beginning of that period, but towards the end they were running set pieces really well. They looked at good looks around the crease, and this time nothing really going. It seems really too. Illini are taking shots and hoping that someone redirects them in front of the net. And honestly, that really did not work at all in this period. They got to change it up in this one. We'll see if they do that.
I think for the third, they definitely need to work on their discipline and having more control in the puck.
Yeah, I agree. This is our fourth game of the season, and all three goalies, Donovan Bird, Royce Allred, and Barnhart, have all pretty much shared the net pretty well. Coach Fabrini has them split in time. Do you think Donovan Bird's in net for that third period, or do you think you'll see Allred in net?
Yeah, honestly, I think the one goal he's given up says a lot more about the defense in this game than he does his goaltending. It's hard when Barnhart pulls a shutout last night, but he also had four goals to assist them. If somehow the Illini lose this game, you can't blame the goaltender. Yeah.
What do you think? Do you think it's a good thing that Coach Fabrini's been adjusting who's been goaltending, or do you think it's something that is going to end up hurting because you don't have that chemistry with your defense, per se?
Yeah, good point. I'm going to say probably not. I think the big reason Barnhart wasn't in is because he played the entire game last week. Give him a rest. The position of goalie in hockey is unbelievable. You take 30 shots a game from like 70 mile per hour rubber pucks that hit you right in the chest, 90 even too. Some of those pucks can reach. So it's a rough sport and a rough position. Don't read too much into the fact that Barnhart didn't start tonight. And I think you can go into the rest of the season positive with all of your goalies. So far.
And I think it's almost better that they switch to the goalies early in the season instead of getting closer to the playoff season and, switching a goalie and the team really doesn't have any chemistry.
I agree.
Yeah, absolutely. Later year we have to play Robert Morris, Lindenwood. You're going to want those guys fresh, so why not, start mixing it up like they have been so far.
So 25 goals in 11 periods for the Illini. Where do you think the offensive production is going to come from in period three?
Well, I mentioned him earlier in the intermission report here. I got to go four far. Trying to get him more open looks. He scored in the last game. Some of those power plays, too, I expected him to do a little bit more. I hope they does a little more for the rest of the period. And, you know, say, on top of that, to add on, they got to score on those power plays.
Yeah, they've they had five or six power plays or penalty kills in that sloppy second period. And I don't know if it's a testament to how good the Illinois State penalty kill has been or how bad our power play has been. But going into the conference season when we have some tougher opponents to play, what do you think the Illini need to do to correct that?
Well, for one, a big part, and it's a big part in college hockey here, the Illini is fighting, you know, ends up putting people in a 4-on-4 opportunity. You gotta cut the fighting back a little bit. I know they had a problem with it last year. It doesn't seem like they're doing it as much this year, but I mean, penalty's a penalty, and if it's really worth fighting in a game, when you're gonna play one of your players in the box, I think not. You know, maybe some players, you know, aggression. It's one of the only sports really where you can get away with fighting.
True.
And not get arrested.
Yeah.
Exactly what Pat's saying. Like, I don't want to sound like a broken clock, but we really definitely need to work on just focusing on the puck and focusing on
winning the game.
Yeah, exactly. Winning the game. Focusing on not letting anything get through.
Yeah, as we head into the conference season and face some tougher opponents, I'm sure Coach Fabrini will be addressing the power play for sure.
Yeah,
one of the things I've also been noting is at the beginning of pretty much every period, the Illini have started slow, maybe gained some speed towards the middle, but I think that's the reason that they're tied in this game and not ahead. What do you think the key to that third period is to not only get ahead, but stay ahead?
You know what? Defense has to be a little bit better. You need to hold possession. What we did in the first period was great. For whatever reason, we weren't scoring on some of those opportunities, and I think hopefully this half that we'll get the puck more, we'll play it like we did in that first period, but score on those opportunities, get those set pieces running, get Forfar involved. I said his name a couple of times so far in this intermission. Why not keep it going? Along with Bobby Emstring too, he's the captain. He had the puck a lot in that first period. Get the puck more, see if he can score.
Yeah, I think it's going to be that first line, Ernsting, Forfar, and Ribba, that are going to pretty much decide the rest of this game.
Yeah.
Another one of the things I wanted to point out is we had about 3 minutes to go in that period, and Wasilewski was diving all over the crease, making back-to-back saves, kind of stuffing Forfar, and he got a little frustrated, and I think he ended up in the penalty box after that, if I'm not mistaken. But what does that have to say about Wasilewski, and why the heck was he not in goal yesterday?
Great. I can't, you know, emphasize how good and how hard it is to play.
Yeah, he's the reason it's 1-1 right now.
Yeah, exactly. I was just telling Patrick during the game that I wasn't here, obviously, but I saw a few clips of the game last night, and it's a definitely good change from Hayden last night.
Yeah, I definitely agree with that. Wasilewski's been kind of stuffing the Illini. The Illini need to find some opportunities to score. Do you think it has to do with puck movement or just puck control? What do you think's the key there?
You know, a good point here. We saw earlier in this game, you know, a couple 2-on-1 opportunities or 1-on-1 with the goalie opportunities, and the shots haven't gone in. Shooting's gotta get better, frankly.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, absolutely. That, you know, the opportunities seem to be there. Puck movement, honestly, in these last two games have been fantastic for the Illini. But the opportunity to be there, shooting's just got to be better.
And it's another thing you touched on a little bit earlier. I think a big key is to stay out of the box.
Yeah, and, you know.
And definitely capitalize when ISU's in the box.
Right. Try and get the puck to the center, too. Honestly, trying to redirect the shots is something that in the NHL works sometimes. But if you see a team do it too much, it's almost like they're trying to do it because they don't know how to score in a game.
Yeah.
Don't want to see that for the Illini. Get the puck in the center. Try and take shots. Try and get it glove side on Wasilewski.
Yeah, and as the season progresses, the Illini are currently ranked number 3 in the nation. They're trying to get that lead or that overall record from 3-0 to 4-0. How important is this game to kind of keeping that number 3 standing and trying to move up?
You never want to lose a game.
Yeah.
Mostly, run against an in-state rival. So definitely important to win this one. I'm confident in the guys going into the second half based on what I saw last night. So we'll see what the adjustments they make early and see if they can pull it off.
Yeah.
On top of just wanting to win games, next week the Illini will have a three-game series. You know, they never know what's going to happen about that. So if they can get a win tonight and possibly two more next weekend, they can be the number one.
Yeah, I agree. As we head to the third period of play, the Illini look for the sweep against Illinois State. We're tied 1-1 after two periods. For Danielle and Patrick, my name's Anthony Pasquale, and we'll send it back to Steven and Eric right after this.
And welcome back, everybody, inside the Big Pond at the Illinois Ice Arena in Champaign, Illinois. It's Illinois Hockey on YouTube alongside Eric Fisher. I'm Stephen Cohn, and 20 more minutes between Illinois and a weekend sweep of in-state rival Illinois State. But it's not going to be easy, Illinois State putting up a fight so far.
Yeah, I mean, we just heard what the shot count was for this game. Illinois has 42 shots on goal, Redbirds 10 shots on goal, but we have a tie hockey game, and that's a lot to do with Corey Wojcicki. He's playing together one of the best goaltending performances I've seen in a long time. He's been just great in that second period. He made some incredible saves, but third period, does he have anything left in the tank? That's the question.
Hey, give me a guy who's going to get that game-winning goal. We're just about underway. Illinois loses the faceoff. They're going to go right to left here in this third period. Who's going to score that game-winning goal?
I'm going to go, I think the captain, Bobby Ernsting. I think he's had some great shot opportunities tonight, and I think he's going to come through for the Illini.
Bobby Ernsting, no goals yet this year, 2 assists last weekend. That ball off the post. Early on, shot number 43 is almost goal number 2.
Yeah, Charlie Solak right at the blue line had a great shot opportunity right off that left post.
19:25 left to go that. Power play for the Illini at 31 seconds remaining has expired. So back to 5-on-5 hockey, where Illinois State has been excellent for the most of tonight. Wasilewski, another great save on the far shot from the right point by Tyler Opilka. And going for that rebound again, but Corey Wasilewski, where he's been so great tonight, has no rebound opportunities.
Yeah, no, in that first period, he was giving them up left and right, but second period, he really cracked down on it. In this third period so far, did a great job covering up that puck, making sure no one else had a chance at a rebound. Stephen Quinn, he was around the puck trying to see if there was anything he could maybe do there, but nothing from Corey Wojcicki.
And Anthony Pasquale, who was on that intermission report, he says Casper, who has the shot right now, is going to score twice in this third period, so we'll see if that happens. That's him. It's kind of ambitious, but that top line needs to get going. It's been the bottom six all weekend long. It's time to see Riva, Ernstig, and Forifar get going in the back of the net, but right now Illinois State in their offensive zone. Hit into the boards is Colada. And now it's them boards. Joe Nolan, nice play to poke that puck away. And it's going to be up to Casper Riva to try to clear it. Two-line pass to Bobby Ernstig. Check that, Luke Forifar. Now it's Ernstig. Ernstig puts a move in a man. He's at the bottom of your screen, near side half boards. Going neutral ice, skating backwards. Joe Nolan covering his man. And now it's Andrew Van Dyke with the puck at the right circle. Van Dyke shoots it high.
Had it.
He did. Donovan Bird leaving him some space there in the net.
Yeah, Bird left him some space on the glove side there, but Van Dyke just a little high. If he was able to bring that down a couple inches, he could have had a beautiful goal glove side.
That puck thrown all the way across the boards. Charlie Salk chasing after it. And a man beats him to it, but they'll want to come away with it. Ricky had it now, trying to clear it. Had him, far side half board. Oh, Justin Reese through an elbow. And that's going to be a penalty. It looks like number 7, Mike Cavanaugh, goes to the ground.
Yeah, he caught him right on the head on that.
Oh, check that. It's number 44, Robert Colato.
Yeah, I mean, Reese just caught him a little high there with the elbow. Got him right in the head. If he was able to bring that down, that would have been a clean hit. But you can't, I mean, you just can't aim for the head like Reese did there, so he's going to head to the box. We'll see. That'll be maybe a major, if anything, or just a normal minor.
Justin Reese, Thomas Cola, Stephen Quinn, we've all seen them in the box several times this weekend. And that's something where the discipline over the past year or two has become really good with this Illinois team in eliminating penalties like that. And that was an issue in the past, maybe the underclassmen years for guys like Eric Cruikshank, James McGing, but they've gotten good at that kind of thing. And they can't be taking these penalties right now.
Yeah, I mean, it just takes a little bit for discipline. Really grow, get the pace of the game, knowing when you can make that hit, know when you can. Right there, Justin Reese can't make that hit. It's going to be a 2-minute minor.
Two minutes for elbowing for Justin Reese, the sophomore from Orleans Park. Reese had a hat trick last Friday night. He's been held scoreless since. Stephen Quinn giving chase. Now it's Neil Novosel, who throws a hit. The Illini put the puck in their offensive zone for about the past 20 seconds, even though they're shorthanded. Neil Novosel now circling, trying to escape with the puck, but instead it's Colada. Colada took that hit from Reese just a second ago that sent Reese to the box, gave Illinois State the man advantage. Colada circles back, thrown all the way back down to Wasilewski.
Whoa.
Well, that was one of the easiest shots he'll face tonight, and he made it a little more difficult.
Yeah, that almost snuck 5-hole on him there. He had to use the back of the skates to make sure it didn't go in.
Sarnecki to Jablonski. Jablonski near side. Now back to Sarnecki. Jablonski again. Jablonski behind the net. Gretzky's office. And Jablonski drops it for Kavanaugh. Over to Corcoran. Corcoran. Sarnecki. Sarnecki right circle. Blocked away. Mark Gandotti. Nice play by him to put his body in front of it. That's Opilka now. He kind of locked Jablonski up against the boards and allowed Kandati to clear it all the way down. Wasilewski, this one a little bit easier for him.
This one he made sure to use the stick instead of bouncing it off the pads.
See, when Illinois gets 50 shots and then they get their second goal off a full ice pass just trying to clear it on a PK, that'd be something else. Offsides, 25 seconds left on Reese's minor for elbowing.
It's looking like there's actually going to be a penalty on the Redbirds potentially here.
Yeah, it's going to be Van Dyke going to the box again. What? I think this is his third time. We don't have official stats, but I feel like Van Dyke has spent a lot of time in the penalty box in the sin bin tonight.
Yeah, and he's the Redbirds' probably deadliest offensive player. So if you're ISU, I mean, you hate to see that, just because you're taking one of your best playmakers off the ice in a very tightly contested hockey game.
Yeah, Van Dyke, the stats don't show it. 1 goal, 2 assists, but he's definitely been very involved
previous
on the offensive
years,
end.
He's been one of the biggest producers in this matchup.
And Corey Schwarz, 6 goals. He had a 6th goal of the season tonight, saved by Donovan Bird. But that's the guy right now you got to circle, I think, Van Dyke and Corey Schwarz, because those are two guys that might get the go-ahead goal for the Redbirds.
Yeah, and you can't forget about Howie either. He's had himself actually a very good game. He drew that one penalty on Evan Sabo on the right wing, so he's another player on this ISU team that's just very deadly offensively.
17 seconds left of 4-4 hockey until the Illini are going to have a minute 35 on the power play. Tower Opilka in the corner. Illinois is going to try to clear. They will. Over the block eye, over the blue line. Tower Opilka gains a zone. He has Bobby Ernsting cutting toward the net. And now he's Ernsting. Ernsting high slot. A chance. That's Casper Ribba. Back to Koa's far side corner. And now it's 5-on-4 for the Illini. Opilka on the ice. Opilka. Ernsting in the right circle. Slap shot from Opilka. Blocked away at Wasilewski.
That's a great kick save by Wasilewski. He saw that puck all the way and perfectly deflected the rebound off to the far boards.
Tower Opilka passing the neutral ice. Stuck at the blue line, though, where the Illini, Thomas Kolas. It's all the way back down. Bobby Ernst thinking 1 minute left of the Illini on the power play. 15:35 left to go in regulation. Tied at one. Illinois State. Saturday Night Hockey at the Big Bun. Joe Nolan. And he loses it. That's not something you usually see from Joe Nolan.
No, he's usually one of the better stick handlers up on the point of attack like that. Careless play by Nolan is going to cost some crucial time on this power play.
Yeah, that took about 20 seconds now for that line to get reset. All of them past the blue line, and that pass almost offsides.
Yeah,
I thought Cole was
passed. ISU bench really wanted offsides there.
And that would have been a big break for ISU again, because Illinois would have shot themselves in the foot twice in one power play.
Not seeing a lot of puck movement right now. Guys holding on to the puck, allowing the penalty kill for ISU to set up.
Finally a chance. Kasper Ribba! Ribba blocked away. It was Wazlewski again.
Yeah, it was right off the left side of the net there on that.
Bobby Ernsting with space. Ernsting sets up.
Great
and an deflection.
Save.
Wow, Wazlewski. Nothing else you could say at this point.
I've said it multiple times. He's been their best penalty killer. He's the best thing I've been seeing out of him on this power play, at least.
And
his
a chance,
ability,
though.
Is his ability to kick the way, cook direct where the puck is going after he makes the save. That's crucial for a goaltender.
Yeah, he's able to get it away from the line. Kasper Ribba. Ribba with a chance. And the redirect, John Moskowa couldn't get his second goal of the game. Corey was a loser.
That was an amazing save, Steven. Oh, my gosh. I mean, Ribba makes the heads-up play by him to make the extra pass to Moskowa. And then Wojciechowski makes the kick save, stuffs the stick from Moskowa, and deflects the puck away. Just a monster save out of Wojciechowski, which has been a monster game for him overall.
Folks, start sharing this broadcast on Facebook. Your friends want to watch this. It's 1-1 here at the Big Pond. 14 minutes left to go. Second weekend for the Illini of the regular season. You are 3-0. And a chance now for number 18, Chris Jablonski. That wide hit the backboards. Krinkos gives chase. That's Salk now. Salk behind the goal line. And starting to Van Dyke was behind him. It's 5-5 again. 13:45 left to go. Moskowuk tries to poke it away into the corner. Ilnovasil with it now. Behind the net. Great pass, Steven Quinn. Quinn! Couldn't get that one. Oh, Wazlewski. Ilnovasil tries to go far side on his blocker. He couldn't get it there. John Moskowuk.
This man's just been ridiculous tonight. I mean, every one-on-one situation Wazlewski's had, he's converted on 100%. He's been kicking the puck away perfectly off to the weaker strong side boards. He's been squaring up the Illinois player whenever he needs it. That time it was Stephen Quinn, who had two amazing scoring opportunities that you'll see him convert on more times than not. And Wojciechowski, I don't know what else to say. This man's doing it all. I feel like I keep repeating myself every time I talk to him, but he keeps making the same amazing play over and over again.
Illinois' offensive strategy now is just me yelling Wazlewski every time they shoot it on that. That's all it is. Under 13 minutes now. Illinois hasn't scored in about over 30 minutes of game time. That's icing on the Redbirds, so Illinois is able to get a change with 12:49 left to go. Alongside Eric Fisher, I'm Stephen Cohn. You're watching Illini Hockey on YouTube. It's just 9 o'clock Central Time now. 7 o'clock start times on Saturday nights at the Big Pond this year. 7:30 on Friday nights. Make sure try to make it down to a game. A lot of great opponents coming in. You got the Jamestown Jimmies in non-conference play. Alabama's coming in at some point in November. You got all the CSCHL teams. It's going to be a great season here at the Big Bun. Not going to want to miss it because this Illinois team is fun to watch.
Yeah, fun to watch, and one of the top teams in the country currently sitting at number 3. But if Illinois falls here in this game, you can maybe see them drop a little bit.
I don't think they want to lose. I think they want to score, but Corey Wazlewski won't let them. Justin Reese loses a check back. Kolaz loses a stick. And Opilka hit into the boards. Avoids a hit. He's going to lead the rush. Mark Gendati now. Gendati, stretch pass all the way to Drew Richter, and Wazlewski's going to sack that up. So what can Illinois do right now to get past Corey Wazlewski, because this is not working?
I honestly have no idea. I mean,
done everything.
They've had great shot opportunity after great shot opportunity. I mean, Stephen Quinn, like I just said, he's going to score on that more times than not, but Wazlewski just standing up tall in front of him, shutting him down. Illinois has been making the right passes in this third period to get good shots on goal, but Wazlewski once again just stops him. If I'm Illinois, I'm just going to keep peppering him, and hopefully one of these go in, because these are very good
big
shots.
Big hit. Evan Sabo goes flying into the boards, gets back up. And Wazlewski glove save. So another offensive zone draw. You want to see Illinois just take, get one pass off the draw and just shoot it at Wazlewski and try to get some redirect?
We'll see who's coming in here. So if it's Bobby Ernsting on the draw, I bet Ernsting goes for his pad in between the between the player's legs and goes for a shot. He scored on that a couple times last year. Kind of turned heads with that move. It's something you didn't really see, but I've got Justin Reese on the draw.
Justin Reese, he wins it. But Illinois State's going to have a chance to clear. Ahead to Pirelli. Pirelli tips it ahead. All the way down. Chasing after his rush. His eighth game has two assists this year. Nice backhand pass by Nolan to Ricky Haddon. Haddon going down high slot. Glove save by Wazlewski.
Easy save.
Illinois's got to be at almost 50 shots now. They have one goal. One.
And that just speaks to what kind of night Corey Wazlewski's having in between the pipes. I mean, that's one of the easier saves he's made here tonight. Just an easy glove save on Ricky Haddon there. But, I mean, this third period has carried over from what he did in the second period, which is make a fantastic stop one after another.
Now let's not lose what Adam Howie did earlier tonight as well, making a diving save on one of Luke Ford's shots.
Yeah, he saved a goal there.
Yeah, that would have been one of the chances where Wazlewski needed to be bailed out earlier. And that's number 89. Andrew Van Dyke, who you said has been dangerous and almost had a goal right there.
Van Dyke thinks he had a goal there, actually. He couldn't believe that that wasn't called a goal.
Casper Urbanow chasing. Here he comes. Spinning back. Pass to Jack Graham. It's tipped. I feel like Casper Urban tried to do too much.
Yeah, Illinois might have called a break there, actually. Maybe that was a goal. We didn't have a vantage point of it because it was on Birds and Blockers.
Oh, great pass to Luke Forfar. Chance for Ribba. And Ribba couldn't get a shot on as Wazlewski blocked that one away as well. But the great pass ahead to Ribba, who was able to give chase to it and hold on. Salk tips ahead, and someone just got a souvenir gun, so. Hopefully, she dropped it back.
Oh,
she
just keep it.
She did the Red Sox.
This must be her first time.
The Giancarlo Stanton thing. Trying to if she hit a guy, it would have been the same thing.
Yeah. This must be her first game, because, I mean, come on.
She's hearing it from the people next door now.
I mean, you got to keep the puck. It's a free souvenir. You usually have to pay for those kind of things.
I think it has an eye on it. It's kind of cool.
Yeah.
Well, they're using it again for gameplay, so hopefully she didn't put any substances on it. 10.5 to go. Colada over Sarnecki. Sarnecki right point to Kavanaugh at the goal line. Kavanaugh to Glennon. Glennon deflected. That shot meets the boards. It's on the stick of Novosel and neutralizes Moskowik. Moskowik over the blue line. Gains his own to the right circle and tipped all the way. It looks like that was going to hit the net, but it won't. Near side corner. Just over 10 minutes left to go. 1-1. No score here in this third period. One goal each for each team. And Wazlewski able to glove that one too and get on top of it. That redirected and he still stuck with it.
That puck was an inch over to the right, that was going to go five hole on Van Dyke. Very good. Very good chance for the Illini there, but Wazlewski once again, right place at the right time to be able to make that stop. I mean, he stopped every sort of shot the Illini's had tonight. A blue line slap shot, stop. Right in front of the net. I mean, he stops it numerous times. He's been flashing the glove, the blocker, both pads. He's just doing it all.
Here we go. We're under 10 minutes left now in the third period. It's 1-1 between Illinois and Illinois State. John Moskowik with the lone goal for the Illini tonight. They had four goals last night. A 4-0 victory over the Redbirds. Cross ice pass to Opilka, far side half boards. And that tipped all the way by number 17, Jacob Amersad. Opilka has to go and retreat. Nice play by Ambrisat. At the half boards in the corner in our blind spot on the broadcast and from the treehouse. Slap shot, Jack Healy. And down goes, I think, Anthony Calcaran. Knowing just that. Slow to get up. He's feeling that one, but he did block Jack Healy's shot. It was Corcoran. Thomas Kowaz at the goal line. Tries to get past Wazlewski, but he can't. Blocked away again. So Opilka over Kendati. Kendati, left point. Joe Nolan. Nolan, right circle. Going in. It's a goal! Joe Nolan puts the line up 2-1 with 8:54 left to go in the third period.
We always talk about what Joe Nolan does defensively with his huge 6'4 frame. But what a snipe. People always forget how much of an offensive threat he is. He can lead the rush. He can do it all offensively. And he has the shot accuracy, most importantly. He goes high glove on Wozelowski, an area that he's been dominant with tonight, shutting down numerous Illini with that. But Joe Nolan, with perfect placement on that shot, gets it right by Wozelowski. And now it'll be interesting to see if this game breaks wide open as the Illini have all the momentum now after Nolan's goal. That's what we were looking for out of Nolan this weekend. We talked about it yesterday. Was him to get momentum heading into next weekend. Maybe that goal will help him out in that regard. Great goal by Joe Nolan to put the Illini up 2-1.
Nolan, out of Arlington Heights, 9 goals, 18 assists the season ago as a freshman. He's looking to topple that this year in a bigger role for this Illinois team. It's 2-1 now, 8:30 left. Mark Condotti credited with the assist on Nolan's goal, as well as Drew Richter. Donovan Bird goes for the glove save. Haven't said Donovan Bird's name much, though. Redbirds haven't gotten that many shots here in this third period yet. Nolan plays behind the net, just at his first goal of the season. Sarnecki, near side. He finds Pushchuk. Pushchuk loses the puck. It's at the bottom of your screen. And Bob Ernston gets a stick on it. And a chance for a 2-on-1, but they won't take it. Luke Forfar all the way into the net. He gets tipped up. So under 8 minutes to go now, the Illini are up by 1. And now, do you feel a little more confident maybe in the Illini pulling out this victory? Because before, when it was 1-1, I felt like Corey Wazlewski and his hot glove might have been the key to victory.
Yeah, no, I think the Illini have a little bit more confidence now. I mean, they definitely have all the momentum at the moment. It's whether or not they're going to try and put the nail in the coffin with the rest of this game, or if ISU is going to play with a little bit more urgency as they are down one with about 8 minutes left to go, or was that the goal that was just a heartbreak for ISU and now they're just going to fall back the rest of the way? It's going to be interesting to see it with how the rest of this game plays out.
ACHA Division I hockey between the Illinois Fighting Illini and the Illinois State Redbirds, separated by about 45 minutes, and a chance now to make it a 3-1 game. Shot on Wazlewski, the shot by Thomas Kolas is saved. Check that, it was Evan Sabo. I get all these 25, 26, and 28. All numbers look the same.
It's tough.
It's tough to tell.
It was great discipline by Wazlewski on that save. Sabo was faking the pass to Hatton, who was right in the middle of the ice. But Wazlewski didn't bite for it at all. He just stayed covering up that left side and stayed down in his butterfly.
Sabo has it. Deke, a toe direct. Justin Reese stops and starts again. Reese shot. Saved by Wazlewski. Blocked away. It's Reese again in the corner. And Reese takes a big hit into the boards. Charlie Salk from the right point. That one skittered away, but it was far enough away from Wazlewski where it wasn't an issue. Into the corner, Justin Reese, 7 Sabo. Paul Prikos comes away with it, the freshman. Out of Glenview. Nick Fabrini thinks he's very well suited with his skill set to make an impact on this team, and he's been paired with Charlie Salk the past few games. Matthew Rush, who falls into his own board. There will be a whistle.
Puck went into the ISU bench.
I thought Stephen Quinn pushed him. No, it's fine. It's all good, but under 7 minutes to go to the Illini. It's a big week ahead. They're going to leave on Wednesday to drive up to North Dakota, which is about a 15-hour drive, to go play Minot State and the Jamestown Jimmies twice. It's going to be 3 total games against 2 of the top 10 teams in the country, 2 teams that they saw in the ACHA National Tournament last year. And, of course, the Jamestown Jimmies have the best nickname of any college in the country. So should be a bunch of good matchups in Illinois. No more really tune-up games for them before that. Shot by John Moskow, looking for his second goal of the game. Stephen Quinn tries to get for it. Number 7, Mike Cavanaugh in the net with Corey Wazlewski. Helps him save that one. 6:25 left to go. Illinois with the puck in their offensive zone. Nice play by Ambersat to put it on a skate to knock it away. He's on the left, he's at the right circle now. And Bird tips away. Over the blue line is Neil Novosel, but loses the puck. Back to neutral ice for the Redbirds. And Matthew Rush tried to just poke it ahead, and he'll go for a change. Illinois, you're feeling just a prevent kind of defense right now. Like, you got the goal, and now just don't give up another.
You sure don't want to give up another goal, but right now I think Illinois is trying to put put the nail in the coffin here and try and get another goal. Right now, line change coming against
the Neil Novosel. Ooh, Mike Cavanaugh took the brunt of that hit from Neil Novosel. That's Connor Bosasi. Bosasi's shot elevated into the air, so above Donovan Bird.
I'm not really seeing a real sense of urgency out of the Redbirds right now. You would think down one in Illinois with all the momentum, but here's 2-on-1.
Drew Richter, Thomas scores! Finds the bag of the net from the left circle. It's 3-1 on Thomas Kolas' third period goal.
That was just textbook right there, 2-on-1. Make sure you get as wide as possible. That way it makes it tougher for the goaltender to have to slide over and cover the other side. And that was just what it proved to be too difficult to be. Kolas did a great job of positioning himself on that left side of the wing. And he was able to make the easy shot, had a wide open net. Wolowski couldn't get quite over there.
Yeah, Wasilewski, it was great for, I don't know, 52 minutes or so. And now the last 2 minutes, I don't think the wheels have really come off. It's just he was having he still had a great night overall.
Still having a great game.
It's only a 2-goal game still, so it's not over at all. But
I'm pretty sure he's faced probably roughly about 60 shots or so here tonight. So to only give up three goals is remarkable.
I give him a ton of credit because definitely above a 90% save percentage tonight when the official stats come out. Maybe close to 95, some of these shots count as shots. 5 minutes left to go. The Illini up by 2 on Thomas Kolas' goal. Glove save by Wasilewski is going to let the rebound go and drop it to his own man as Illinois State needs to hurry up if they want 2 goals on Donovan Bird, who's been pretty good all night as well. Joe Nolan thrown ahead all the way and icing. I don't know if I like that call for that play from Joe Nolan.
Yeah, I mean, it's just a careless play. I mean, it allows, I mean, they have to stay on the ice. They're not able to get fresh skates on there. And ISU's able to make a change. Maybe, I mean, there's still plenty of time left in this hockey game for ISU to tie it up. If they get a little bit more sense, a little bit more urgency, a little bit more desperation in their play, you never know what will happen.
Yeah, what do I know? Maybe just a miscommunication in that case, but now you have to face that offensive zone draw for the Redbirds.
Yeah.
Chance for him to really set up some offense, make it a 1-goal game. Still 4:39 left, so a ton of time as the Illini are only ahead by 2 with 2 third period goals.
Yeah, this is a key draw. I mean, Healy gets kicked out too, which is why we saw Van Dyke win the draw there, which is a small play that actually mattered to Nate a lot, especially in a closer game. I mean, it worked out in the end for him, but having your center kicked out in what is a big draw can really have a huge effect.
Jack Healy, another one of these freshmen. Another freshman is Vince Savino. I don't think he's played yet tonight. Defenseman and forward, depending on the night. 4:12 left. Illini up by 2. Luke Forfar with the keep, and now back in neutral ice it goes. Tipped away by number 89, Andrew Van Dyke. Into neutral ice we go. That's Van Dyke. Van Dyke stops and starts. And nice play by Paul Frigos to stop him. As it's going to be a delayed penalty, though, that's going to send on a line into the penalty box. It looks like it'll be Neil Novosel. Check that, Luke Forfar.
So, I mean, Illinois just shooting themselves in the foot here. They're giving ISU yet another opportunity to try and get something going on the power play. Oh, I thought Howie was actually skating to the box there for a second. It was going to be 4-4. That seemed to be the theme of the night. It was coincidentals, but I mean, Redbirds going to the power play, get a timeout here from Fabrini, I want to say, to try and make sure that they tighten this up and don't give the Redbirds a chance to come into this. Illinois State called the timeout.
Yeah, Illinois State's going to call their one timeout for tonight's game because this is the moment now, 3:55 left. I think you got to score in the next minute or so in this power play, get back to 5-on-5, have about 3 minutes left, down by 1, and then really have that sense of urgency. But it's going to start now for the Redbirds. Who needs to step up for the Redbirds? You've been talking about Andrew Van Dyke, talking about Corey Schwartz, who has the 1 goal this weekend for them. Are those the guys right now?
Yeah, I mean, you have to look at your top players. In situations like that, this is a make or break power play. If they don't score on this power play, then their chances of winning this game go down significantly. So you need your top guys. You need Howie. You need Van Dyke. You need Schmoll. You need all of them to be huge contributors on this, and you need one of them to break through for you.
And they're going
to
pull Corey Wasilewski right now, so they're going to use 6 skaters, go 6-on-4. This is very aggressive with 4 minutes left in the game.
Yeah, it's interesting to say the least. Plus with how aggressive, you know, this Illinois penalty.
Yeah.
Penalty kill unit.
They've been
is,
so good at shorthanded this
they're
year.
They're very aggressive on the offensive end with this penalty kill. So
this is a bold
we'll
move
see how
from,
this plays out. But another man having a two-man advantage is very significant.
Yeah, this is a bold move from Bobby DiNardi, head coach for Illinois State. We'll see if it works out for him.
It just shows you how much he knows how like. DiNardi knows how important this power play is. He knows that if they don't score on this power play, then it's pretty much game.
Well, Andrew Van Dyke to Howie, the right wing. They're across the blue line. And a chance to set up. Howie the goal line. Sends it back to Pushchuk. Over to Van Dyke. Van Dyke to Pushchuk. Pushchuk to the right circle. Stop, starts. It's on Donovan Bird. It's on Skate. It looks like Bird was able to wrap that one up. So nice play by Donovan Bird with a lot of traffic in front of him.
Yeah, that might have been one of his better saves of the night. It was just a little save right there that many people don't really see much coming from. But actually, that puck was actually sliding in a wide open right side of the net, but last second, Bird was able to get his left pad on to stop it. Then he did a great job of controlling it and not giving up a rebound and covering up the puck. Just a little thing out of there that's actually very significant.
Van Dugner's thing on the draw to the left of Donovan Bird. Bird a righty. Nice keep by Pushchuk. Yeah, back to Pushchuk now. Pushchuk, the right side, tried to center it, and Bobby Ernstein now. He has a chance, he throws it ahead. Bobby Ernstein just missed to the right of the empty net where Corey Wasilewski was. They've gone with an empty net. 3:05 left to go, 1:10 left on Luke Forfar's two-man minor.
Yeah, I think Ernstein probably wants that one back too. 9 times out of 10, I'm pretty sure he makes that goal. I mean, that's
they make them in their intermission thing. Like the fans that come out on the ice, they make them.
Fans do it.
There's Van Dyke.
Good
block. Shots in there.
Good block from Candotti with the right shoulder there. Well, just Grimson just a tad bit. Maybe that's why he's coming off the ice. Just kind of had stretching out the shoulder a little bit, but great block from him.
Hey, Donovan Bird. He's played 4+ periods, almost 5. He's allowed 1. Goal over that time, so I think Nick Fabri has 3 solid net minders he's seen so far over these first 2 weekends of play.
Yeah, I mean, Bird hasn't really seen a whole lot of shots tonight, but on the ones he have, he's been solid. Just making sure to keep the puck out of the back of the net.
Joe Nolan throws it on the boards. 45 seconds left. I'm looking forward for his 2-man minor. That's Van Dyke. Finds Howie. Back to Van Dyke. Van Dyke slap shot coming. Save! Donovan Bird with his glove. It gets knocked in after, but the whistle already came. So Donovan Bird once again able to make nice play on the slap shot from Andrew Van Dyke.
Yeah, that was a laser too from the blue line. I'm surprised that didn't catch a body or anyone like that. Just came straight through. Great job on Bird's part, making sure he had vision of the puck to know where it was coming, and then great job to cover it up too. He's been Illinois' best penalty killer so far, and that's what a goaltender is on your penalty kill.
Here we go again, Rush and Novosel. Based off one by that line, it stays in the Redbird zone. It goes to Sarnecki, near side, the bottom of your screen. Into the corner, Jono takes a hit from Rush. Fighting for it is Schwartz. Has the one goal tonight. Schwartz has the puck on a stick, and now it's Jono. Jono flips it all the way ahead, and that goes in. Oh, no, it won't. 15 seconds left on the PK for the Illini. 4 short-handed goals so far this season. They're up by 2-3-1 right now. Jablonski with 8 seconds left of the 6-on-4. Going down the right side, pass to Van Dyke. Van Dyke's played the whole 2 minutes of this power play. The shot hits the cage, and Bird knocks it away. It stays, but now it's 6-on-5. And a great play by Stephen Quinn, who once again gets the puck first before anyone else coming off the bench.
Yeah, he came off the bench just fired up. I mean, he came in there and make the puck, disrupt the play in the neutral zone a little bit.
Hey, maybe it hasn't been Wasilewski tonight. Maybe the Illini just have struggled scoring, but it's been empty net for 2.5 minutes, and the Illini haven't been able to capitalize. Redbirds, a few nice shots on Donovan Bird, but he's really, really stepping up here in the final minutes of this game.
Yeah, I mean, the only shot that probably should have went in was Ernstings, but besides that, I mean, Redbirds doing a great job of keeping the puck in the Illini zone here so far in these final couple minutes.
Kalata and Ernsting on the draw. Robert Kalata out of Park Ridge, the captain of this Illinois State Hockey Club. Thrown down by Van Dyke, who I don't think is going to come off the ice for the final 6 minutes of this game or so. And why would you? Probably been the best player all night. Shot by the Redbirds. Another save by Bird. Behind them now. Back to Van Dyke. Van Dyke circling. The shot from Pushchuk blocked away and goes all the way down. It won't go in. That goes to the right of it. 75 seconds left. Icing called on the Illini. So still 6-on-5. Wasilewski sits and watches on the bench as his Redbirds trail by two. Can Illinois State do anything else right now? They just got to keep pressuring and peppering Donovan Berger, hoping they get two in the back of the net.
Exactly. Now that there's no longer a power play, it's very risky for the Illini to go for that long stretch goal, because if they miss the net, it's going to be an icing just like that, and the puck's going to come right back in their own zone, and they're not going to be able to change. So if you're going to take that shot, you have to know 100% you're going to get it.
Great play by Casper Rubin again for that one. Intercept that pass and sends it down now back to the blue line. With the neutral ice, the keep. Now it's Casper Ribba again. Ribba with some space. He got the shot on it. He might have a chance for a goal. Gets past one man. Still an empty net. Turns thing. Back to Ribba. 53 seconds. Ribba face to the blue line. And now a chance for a 3-on-2 for the Redbirds. That's Van Dyke. Blocked away by Charlie Salk.
It's a huge block, because you never know. There could have been a rebound opportunity off of that. So just a great play by Salk to get the block shot.
Here we go. Charlie Salk chips it ahead. It was all the way down. Illinois able to go for a change. 35 seconds left. They're up by two. 30 seconds left now. Still 6-on-5. Ambershad heads to the bench. It's in the Illini's offensive zone. 20 seconds left, unless there's some kind of miracle. Looks like Illinois is going to pull off their fourth win to open this 2018-19 campaign. Adam Howie going on the right side. Howie at the goal line. Saved by Donovan Bird. That one won't get in the back. 12 seconds left. Illinois State. It's thrown ahead by Thomas Colas. That one might have a chance. Drew Richter puts it in the back of the net. 4-1 lead with 3.5 seconds left. Drew Richter puts the icing on this cake, and a great weekend for the Illinois Fighting Illini.
Drew Richter, many people call him the fastest player on this team. He showed it there. He burnt two ISU defenders there, and then just easily puts a puck in the back of the net. Burns out after the goal. As soon as he hit it in, he just slammed into the boards and on the ground. He just laid there for a second. Thomas Colas came over laughing. And so
great pass from Colas, though. Full-ice pass. Yeah. And Richter able to go.
I don't think that's what Colas was
going
for.
No, I don't think so. I think he was just trying to clear in that case and hoping someone maybe gets to it. Of course, Richter is quick. 3-2-1. Tyler Opilka throws the puck back, and that's how this weekend series comes to an end. It entered the third period tonight 1-1 with Illini, with 3 goals inside the final 10 minutes of this game, and they escape with their fourth victory, open the season here at home.
And that just shows you the difference between the teams. When the pressure came on, the Illinois rose to the occasion. While ISU just clearly looked like the outmatched team in the final 10 minutes. Illinois' playmakers stepped up, and Bobby Ernsting and Thomas Colas and Joe Nolan. Those were the guys that we were talking about in this at the end of the second period that needed to step up, and that's exactly what they did. Your playmakers stepped up when you needed them in the final 10 minutes. That's what you got out of the Illini.
Now let's go with it. 3 stars for today's game. Who's number one?
Number one, I'm going with Corey Wozlowski. This game could have easily been exactly what I called it, a 6-1 or 7-1 hockey game, but he made an incredible save. So many incredible saves. I mean, Drew Richter probably should have had 2 or 3 goals on the night. Stephen Quinn probably should have had a goal on the night, but Wozlowski just stuffing them throughout the game. He had a great performance. And I'm going to go with Joe Nolan. He had the game-winning goal to really give the Illini momentum. And then I'm going to go Thomas Colas, who put the Illini up 3-1 to really wrap this game up.
And then Colas had the assist on the last play of the game on Drew Richter's second goal of the season. So Illinois now, they head to North Dakota. They're going to go play Minot State. They're going to play the Jamestown Jimmies. A big weekend ahead, but they have a goose egg in the loss column. Nick Fabrini's club 4-0 entering those big games. Start off this campaign just like they did last year with 4 consecutive W's. For Eric Fisher, Anthony Pasquale, Daniel Williams, and Patrick Cazzo, and I'm Stephen Cohen. Have a good night, everyone. We'll be back in 2 weeks when the Illini play here again against Central Oklahoma at the Big Pond. Illinois wins this one 4-2.